Oh.
That's love right there. That's love.
You know you're set for a really good Friday when you step into it with a bit of laughter, right?
Oh, man, we absolutely love it. No, we're laughing because there's all sorts of shenanigans going on behind the scenes. You'll find out why today, but a very good morning. Welcome to it from myself, Graham Richards.
And myself, Thabiso Makubela, your Uncle Tabzi. You've made the right choice. You've chosen to wake up on the right side of bed today. You've chosen your feel-good breakfast show, Espresso. It's a fry-yay as well.
Oh, it is, and it's a massive fry-yay. Add that. So, dude, on the sporting front, it doesn't get much bigger than it does at the moment. In fact, I'm going to brace myself, prepare myself with a coffee. Princess, my queen, save me. Save me, my dear.
Well, you're absolutely going to love it, and we're going to be needing those predictions coming through from you. You're going to have to be part of the action. Give us a call later on the show. Let us know what you think is going to happen, but it's going to be quite chaotic.
It is going to be a massive weekend. So we've got, obviously, Man City have climbed back to the top of the Premier League table, so we're going to be chatting about that this morning. So we want the Liverpool supporters fans to give us a shout. Is your season imploding as we speak? Is it slipping out of your grasp? I don't think it is, but we want to hear from you guys. Then, of course, we've got the Soweto Derby. Yes. And at the moment, the Buccaneers holding sway. Albeit Chiefs have the bigger picture, but it's a lot of pressure on the Bucks at the top of the table as well. So we want to hear from you, the fans, who's going to take probably the most iconic footballing fixture in the league. 021-430-9881. Give us a shout.
Yeah, Ewan, what's happening in there?
Yo, good morning, man. I can feel it. It's gearing up to be an epic Friday. Good morning, guys. Ewan Stratum here, hanging out with you. It's your Fry-yay morning, and I'm looking forward to this one, man, because the weekend is here. It's been a big week. It's been a hot day yesterday in Cape Town as well, man. At least we're taking a break from the heat this morning, but good to have you. Thank you very much. Our Professor Fashion Editor is here as well. Nick Swillers, everyone.
Who is this?
Oh, my God. Who is this?
It's the loudest.
Dude.
I've never gotten.
Well, it's only me, and yeah.
Yeah, but you can make some noise.
Listen, I've always wanted to ask, before we do anything,
yeah.
What's in the pouch, man?
I did this the other week.
I wasn't here.
I'm not revealing twice.
No, see, okay, just...
There's a few goodies in there.
Graham, get in here, bro.
Yeah. You know, it's a man's purse is a private affair.
Okay, so that's right? The first box we've ticked is that you called it a purse.
It's a man's purse.
own entity. I'm just glad it's not around the waist, though.
Yeah, but sometimes I don't put anything in here.
Oh, really? So just
there's a trick. That's just, my tidbit. Aesthetics, guys. You don't need... This doesn't have to be functional. This is a lot.
By the end of the show, we will find out what's in there.
Will we?
I'm just very keen to know. Because it suits you, man. It really does. So listen, fashion-wise, today...
Listen, you're in stripes. I don't know if you realize.
I do, and it's horizontal stripes.
Oh my God, you are good. Yeah.
Because he needs to look bigger, right?
We needed to add a little girth there.
But I like that you said that because I'm actually disproving what you just said,
really?
Mr. Richards.
Really?
A lot of people think, and women particularly, but we can equate this to men as well, that horizontal stripes are actually the ones that broaden and vertical slim. It's actually the other way around.
Oh. What?
You actually won't be
I'm
able to tell.
I'm not putting on a dress, bro. Huh? It's a shirt.
Or a shirt dress.
I like
Knee, no pants, belted,
okay,
tights.
You mean,
here we go.
Yeah. Here's a man bag.
I'm not a scientist or mathematician, but I read in an academic journal, a scientist studied the effects of stripes in a single square. And through the dimensions, I'm not an Einstein, okay? I might be Jewish, but that's all I have in common with it. I'm not going there. But what he found is that actually looking at square by square with horizontal and vertical, the vertical stripes, which is this way, actually tended to elongate.
To broaden your
To broaden, wow. and the horizontal were slimming.
Okay.
I'm just saying.
Well, you look marvelous.
Thank you. You look svelte.
Thank
you.
Svelte.
You are
as Nick and I
described yourself.
Thank you. Yeah, no, I went for a flow. I went for a nice flow.
This is a long sleeve shirt, and it's white.
that's
all I got.
What does that mean? What
that's
does that do
all,
for?
It
fills you with confidence. I actually feel cool though. It is.
Okay.
It's crisp. It's cool, and we've been so hot. Dude, is that going to continue this weekend? Is there any respite?
Dude, look, I know that in parts of the country it's still going to be very, very hot, but we'll give you the main cities very quickly. Johannesburg, you can expect intervals of clouds and sunshine. A thunderstorm also, and a couple of showers is also expected in the afternoon and also into the evening with little to no wind. So it's going to be a beautiful one. You can enjoy those thunder showers, and humidity will decrease as the evening approaches. So don't forget your raincoats if you are leaving home, and you're going to be home later only. Then Durban, partly cloudy conditions for the majority of the day, with a northeasterly breeze traveling around 22 kilometers per hour. The wind will die down towards evening and humidity increases, and temperatures will remain steady, reaching a nice and hot maximum, and I'm sure a humid maximum of 31 degrees as well. Port Elizabeth, PE, the friendly city, the windy city. You can expect times of clouds and sunshine with a breeze in the afternoon, and towards the evening, cloud cover will increase, and rain is also expected from tomorrow onwards. So hold on to your hats and whip out those umbrellas, and take a look quickly at Cape Town, a morning shower in the area with clouds giving away home, giving away to some sun. It's very cloudy in the morning. There's this fine mist rain as well going on at the moment, but cooler temperatures with a light southwesterly breeze can be expected. The wind will pick up towards the evening, reaching a maximum temperature of around 25 degrees. So enjoy a bit of sunshine later on. So
yes,
we'll run you through the full weather report in just a little bit.
And we know the triathlon, the first big triathlon of the year. If you've been wondering why there've been barriers set up, it wasn't just for sauna, but they're also setting up for triathlon. So the weather, a break in the heat is good.
It is good. And cotton is always good to go. I mean, cotton or linens. I mean, it's obviously like a short sleeve you're going to wear when it's hot. But you can do long sleeve in a linen or a linen blend. So make sure you're doing organic cottons and linens. Yeah. Long sleeve, you can still breathe incredibly well if it's a linen or a cotton blend.
Okay, can I just quickly mention that my world was completely turned upside down with his horizontal and vertical stripes. So if you want to look thinner or slimmer, horizontal stripes.
Yes.
Horizontal, man.
Okay.
Google it.
He doesn't actually even believe it, but we'll put it to the test today.
Changed.
Does Ewan look bigger or smaller than he
normally
does?
That's a Twitter question.
Does.
A poll. Let's get a poll.
Let's get a poll.
Not that kind of poll.
Let's see if you look any slimmer after eating chocolate cupcakes this morning. Let's find out what's happening in the kitchen.
Wow, you guys were eating up those fashion tips, but you know, talking about eating, we're in our kitchen and we are making the most, the sweetest, most delicious, fun treats today with Super M, starting off with some Super M chocolate cupcakes. This is gonna be on the menu today. They look absolutely wonderful. The icing is good, the cupcake is amazing. And then of course, we're gonna decorate it with all sorts of yummy, chocolatey goodness.
Chocolatey goodness, I think that's the best way to start off your day. And if you think that's not much of a treat, we've got another Super M treat for you. And of course, if we're making these little rice popsicles with white chocolate, as you can see, and I'm assuming we will be using the strawberry flavor over here.
Our star ingredient.
If you want to get a head start, the keyword for this particular recipe would be treat to 33728.
Absolutely, and then we're going to make possibly the thing that's going to take my Friday to a next level, because it's combining two things that I love, cheese and bread. Mm-hmm. You guys, we're making cheesy pull apart bread. Can you taste it? In your mouth, it's gonna be in your belly, and there's gonna be a party. Oh, I cannot wait. It's gonna be absolutely delicious.
Okay, well, we've got some awesome recipes coming up, but let's find out what else is coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Well, lots coming up on your Feel Good Breakfast Show this morning. So next year, we're talking about some makeup
touching this.
Nice. Oh, really?
I can't let it go.
It does feel nice.
What's the story with the striped top?
And also nautical.
It slims you down. Horizontal stripes. Yeah.
The nautical vibe. Every time I wear a striped shirt, people are like, are you
hey,
a cruise
sailor.
Headliner?
Are you a sailor?
And I'm here to say that is outrageous.
He's actually lying. His yacht is just parked down the sea.
I'm afraid of water. I don't swim.
It's mud.
No, it's parked because it's actually parked it on the sidewalk.
I don't get it. I don't understand that joke. Moving from stripes to beauty.
Yes.
We're here, and I love that we've been having a lot of conversations with the fellas lately about skincare and beauty routine, because it's nice to like give people opportunities to see how men approach these things.
Absolutely, and men's grooming has been coming a very long way. We've spoken about that as well.
Absolutely.
And men are kind of taking much more care about their skins and the routines, and they're getting routine going. First of all, Graham clearly doesn't.
Especially in the slightly older gens. Now, we've spoken a lot about that.
We've had a nice sort of conversation about problematic skin.
Well,
What's your sort of go-to when it comes to maintaining flawless skin? Because you have great skin.
Yeah, thank you very much. I keep it basic, man. I don't want to do too much. I used to have pretty bad skin when I was younger.
Yeah.
But what I've learned is, don't overload my skin with too much washes and soaps and creams and that kind of thing. So it's a simple mild soap that I wash my face with cold water. I like to use cold water.
Yeah.
And then about three times a week, I use this a scrub. At the moment, I have this activated charcoal scrub.
Yeah.
That really
the charcoal
works.
Is in. That is like the biggest sort of item
in
right now.
In everything. Charcoal is the new black.
So that's pretty much what I do, man. That's pretty much what I do. And then when I get here in the morning, it's just one of these guys. There's literally nothing on it. It's one, two, three, and it's done.
Because
it feels comforting to use. It's so soft.
I just use it for the feel of it.
Big artist, like, should I put anything on here? You're like, absolutely not.
I don't take it away.
But I think that's a good point as well. Like, less is more a lot when it comes to beauty as well. You don't want to irritate the skin and strip the skin of its natural oils.
You know what I find? Because I've been in this routine for quite a while, especially with cold water and really like mild soap, if I use things like your moisture creams and those kind of things, my skin tend to turn very oily because it's not used to that kind of thing. And then you start with a little bit of breakouts and those kind of things. So if you keep it plain and simple, your skin can do what it needs to do.
Yeah.
Which I find interesting. It's okay. Just breathe, exactly, yeah. Exactly. And you keep it clean, man. Yeah, exactly.
It's simple. It really is, you can keep it the less is more, like I said, like one or two steps and you're good to go.
And for someone like you and who absolutely doesn't need it, then you don't need to complicate it.
Oh, yeah. Stop it.
You know,
because he's a simple guy. I love him. There was a veiled dude in there.
No, it's just like he doesn't need it. It's all laid out to perfection. Well, let's chat some entertainment news. There's some really good news this morning to share with you.
Good,
a
man.
New addition to the Mandela family legacy.
Oh, okay.
Cool, yes, so there's a new addition to the Mandela family, granddaughter of Nelson Mandela and Winnie Madikizela Mandela, Zoleka. She gave birth to a baby girl, Zenzile Motuba Mashala, as she confirmed via Instagram on Wednesday night. So baby Zenzile apparently arrived 6 days ahead of schedule, but her mother's water broke while she was pecking away the dishes. It happens during the most random time.
Classic.
When you least expect it. She was in labor for about 5 hours, then Javi welcomed their new baby. So she used the moment to pay tribute to the most important people in her life that she's lost, including obviously her grandma, Ma Winnie, and her own two children, Zenani and Zenawe. And in 2011, her son, Zenawe, passed soon after birth due to complications. So we wish her all the best with her now 5 children, her husband, and boundless amounts of love with her little bundle of joy.
They deserve everything.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Happy news.
And family is growing.
Yeah, it is.
Oh man, I absolutely love that. So let's continue on quite a loved up trend this morning. I don't know how you feel about this. They're calling her everyone's like the darling or girl next door in Hollywood, but I think she's got a bit of edge, man. Yeah, J-Law is officially off the market. I think she's quite out there and edgy and real. Like, yeah. I don't really see her as the girl next door.
I wouldn't say edgy. I think she's quite conservative, but she's the girl next door. I think she's approachable.
Every interview, that's the thing. I think she's authentic. She's down to earth. Yeah. She keeps it real, and she's not afraid of laughing at herself.
What do you mean when you say she's off the market?
She is getting married. So, of course, she was married to acclaimed director Darren Aronofsky. They got divorced, so everyone thought it was over. But she is now officially engaged to art gallerist Cook. I don't know if I'm saying it right.
Cook.
You gotta say Cook.
Cook, man.
He's a little kooky, but he's Cook Maroney. And this broke earlier this week, obviously, so as a J-Lo fan, you probably knew this before, right?
She's off the market.
But what everyone, of course, is talking about now is who's gonna be invited to the wedding, who's gonna be the bridesmaid. She's got some pretty powerhouse friends. I think a lot of people thinking Emma Stone, because they appear to be really good on-screen mates and off-screen mates as well. But they've thrown names like Brie Larson, Woody Harrelson, Amy Adams, Bradley Cooper, obviously. Yeah. They've starred together in Silver Linings Playbook. So she's got this incredible list of superstar friends as well. So that wedding is going to be like a paparazzi.
Bradley's going to probably be performing as well.
Now that we know that he can sing. Yeah. Who knows? I hate it when people can just do everything like that.
Yeah, it just like makes you feel like, are you even delivering enough? But forget all of that. I'm just sitting here and thinking,
my skin good enough.
You know, always brings it in terms of looks. So can you imagine what that wedding gown's going to be like?
She's going to be beautiful.
Dude, she's not going to have to pay for it. That's what I know.
Do you call them J-Mar, Cooklaw, Cooklaw? What do you call them now?
J-Cook.
J-Cook.
Maybe?
J-Cook.
I like that.
J-Cook.
But it's the cookie, J-Cook.
It's been interesting because it's almost like being the year of engagements and marriage. I mean, we're only in February now, and so many people, local celebrities as well, have been getting engaged and they're getting married. I know one of my favorite actors, Chris Pratt.
That was quite quick though, eh?
Dude,
he just wanted to marry her. Do it quickly.
Catherine Schwarzenegger. Well, she said yes.
Well, you guys are having that moment. We're going to start you off on a nice and really positive note. Okay, here's a quote for today. I know I can be what I want to be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I want to be.
That sounds like a very hard line. Do you want to wrap it for us?
Yeah.
Come on.
No, I'm not gonna try that. Too early to be embarrassing myself. I know I can be what I want to be. If I work hard at it, I'll be where I want to be. Guess who this came from? Nas gave this to us back in 1994.
Nice.
So it's pretty straightforward. You can be what you want to be if you put your mind to what you want to be. Hey, boom!
Just be nice.
Let's end the show. On that note, let's go. Step into the day with the dawn.
Feel good.
Welcome to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Time for us to catch up with what's happening in the world of news. In the national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa announced in his State of the Nation address in Parliament in Cape Town last night that the country would head for the polls in the general election on the 8th of May. He also announced that debt-laden Eskom would be split into three parts. The French oil giant Total yesterday announced that it had made a significant natural gas discovery about 180 kilometers off the coast in Mossel Bay. The so-called Brilpadda found is estimated at about 1 billion barrels. On the international front, heads of state and government representatives are gathering in Ethiopia this week for a meeting of the African Union. The meeting's main focus will be on the refugee crisis. The diplomatic row between France and Italy yesterday deepened, with France complaining of unfounded attacks and outlandish claims by Italian leaders. France recalled its ambassador for Italy for talks, saying the situation was unprecedented since World War II. And finally, a 30-year-old security guard in Kanyiso Xaba bravely pulled bedridden patients from a burning ward at Mpumulo Hospital in Kwa Mapumulo in the Ilembe district of KZN before collapsing due to smoke inhalation. Xaba, who is employed by a private security firm at the hospital, also unhesitatingly burst through a window to rescue a nurse and a patient who were trapped in a smoke-filled ward. KZN Health MEC Dr. Sibongiseni Dlomo praised Xaba as being a hero for literally pulling his own life, putting his own life on the line to save the lives of others. Xaba says that he is proud to have done what he did and would not hesitate to do it all over again. Meanwhile, he has also intimated that he was not had not lost hope of one day becoming a police officer. Well, that is a wonderful feel-good story to end off the news bulletin. Time for us to take a look at what's happening in the very exciting world of sport. Here's Graham.
Oh, thank you so much, Leanne. I am Graham Richards. Let's delve into a very, yes, exciting weekend of sports. 8 Premier League fixtures and counting this weekend. But it will undoubtedly be the Liverpool and Bournemouth match that everyone's watching to see if Liverpool can come out on top. Anything more than a loss, we'll see them back on the top of the log and front footing for that title race. Then we stay with football. Another big stakes weekend tomorrow evening. The Soweto Derby is set to take place at the Orlando, or rather FNB Stadium, between Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs. Historically, the match has been won by Chiefs at a narrow 25-21, but of course Pirates holding sway in recent history. And on to rugby. Six Nations rugby continues this weekend with three upcoming fixtures. Saturday, see Scotland taking on Ireland, as well as Italy and Wales. Then on Sunday, we've got the powerhouse edition, England, taking on old foes, France. And then on to cricket, the Proteas. They'll have little time to rest on their laurels after this weekend's T20 victory in a clean sweep over Pakistan. Sri Lanka's national cricket team make their way to Mzansi shores this coming Wednesday. And historically, South Africa have fared better in their fixtures against the Lions than they have with Pakistan, which bodes well. We'll delve a little deeper into all of our weekend sport, and we are opening the lines for your predictions about the Soweto Derby and more. 021-430-9881. Give us a shout.
Thank you, Graham. Well, let's take a first and proper look at the rest of the temperatures across the country. We first want to say thank you to the beautiful sunrise photos that's been coming through. ASA sent us this gorgeous skyline from Houdini. Today, you can expect humid conditions as well as a bit of cloud cover, reaching a maximum of 21 degrees Celsius. On that note, Polokwane, let's start with you. Your minimum for today is 15, your maximum 29. Partly cloudy in Mbombela today with a high of 30. Pretoria, 18, reaching a high of 20. Johannesburg 17, reaching a high of 27. If you're in Mahikeng, 18 is your low, 30 your high. Klerksdorp 18 with a high of 31. Kimberley 20, reaching a high of 32. If you're in Bloemfontein today, 18 with a high of 31 can be expected. Richards Bay 23, reaching a high of 32. Partly cloudy conditions in Pietermaritzburg, your high is 36. Durban 24 with a high of 31. If you're in Mthatha, 19 with a high of 38 can be expected. East London 20 reaching a high of 33. It's sunny in Cradock with a high of 39. If you're in Port Elizabeth, 19 with a high of 28 can be expected. George 17, 26. Sutherland 18, 32. And Cape Town, your low is 18, your high 25 degrees Celsius. If you're in Worcester today, sunny and warm conditions, a high of 36. Springbok 19, reaching a high of 29. And Upington, your low is 22, your high 32 degrees Celsius. We'll touch on those weather temperatures again in a half an hour.
Thank you very much, Zoe. Yes, now that your Friday is officially underway.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good.
Welcome.
You guys were having a very deep conversation.
Bambanizander. I was just like, let's kumbaya, my lord.
Welcome. Good morning.
All right.
Well, we've got the show officially on the road, but we do need to take a bit of a break so we get those systems nicely oiled up and polished up. After the break, we're taking it to the kitchen at some point, making something really nice. Some delicious lunch treats for the kids brought to you by Super M.
It's got marshmallows involved, so it's going to be delicious. Oh, and then, of course, it's a big weekend, dude. The Soweto Derby is taking place. We have our sports journalist, Carl Lewis, with us. He's going to be running us through all the action. It's going to be an action-packed weekend.
And I also love how Ewan's smiling like he doesn't know what's happening, what's coming up. It's a Friday. You know
what are you talking about?
You know
what
that means. Did you put lotion on your hands?
I have no idea.
It's a Friday.
It's a Friday.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Espresso, and time for us to connect with you on social media. Just to give you some context, what's happened in this picture was yesterday when Kat and Casper Njorvest was playing Emoji Charades. But of course, we want to know from you what exactly is giving you that Friday feeling. And to connect with you on social media, this is what you had to say. Natasha says, good morning, Espresso family. Knowing I can sleep late tomorrow and having a movie weekend with my fiance, that is giving Natasha the Friday feelings. Lindy says, it's Friday feeling to be free, friends, hangout, beach, all that and more. But Durban is a little bit misty and overcast. I still got the flu and still on my way to have a lot of fun as I can as usual. Well, Lindy, thank you for staying optimistic and, of course, sharing your weekend plans with us. But if you have something that's giving you that Friday feeling right now, head on over to our social media pages and share it with us using that hashtag #ExpressoShow.
Yeah, and while you do that, remember it's also time for your weekend sports preview. Our friend in sport, Carl Lewis, is here to share his thoughts and his predictions for this weekend's fixtures. And of course, we want to hear your thoughts as well. Big matchups coming up. Give us a call, 0214309881. Tweet us, Instagram us, Facebook us, hashtag Espresso Show. Let's get inside.
I think I dreamt about this last night. Carl, welcome back, buddy. These are the weekends we live for, my brother. Football dominating this weekend. We know we've seen Ireland lose in the Six Nations, which seems to have created a bit of a wave in rugby, bringing them back down to earth. But everything has to be focused on the big one, the Soweto Derby this weekend. Let's set the Premier League aside. This is massive. This is the biggest fixture in local football.
On the African continent.
Yeah, man, hands down, and rightly so. But and I'm, please don't hate me. And if you do hate me, phone in 021-430-9881 and express your opinion. But it feels like these two teams are in a different league from each other this year. Pirates holding sway. We know the Chiefs hold the longer record, I think 25-21 or something in their overall standings. But Pirates, despite fighting multiple battles, they are in the hunt for a title. They're in the hunt for glory on the continent. Where's Chiefs this season? What is a good result for Middendorp? Is there pressure on him this season?
Well, at Kaizer Chiefs, you're a glamour boy. There is always pressure. Just a quick stat. This match beams out to over 50 countries over the world. So.
Wow.
This is huge.
That is amazing.
But getting back to Chiefs, I think, you know, they're expected to win every game, whether they fired their coach the game before or not. There is an expectation with your interim coach. So I think there is pressure on Middendorp. But if you look at the league standings, they're quite off the pace. So I think a top four finish is probably what they're looking for, because it seems like Wits, Sundowns, and obviously Pirates, those are the title chasers, and that's who we need to watch. I don't think Amakhosi are there this season.
But there's always something of a bit of a magic when it comes to the Soweto Derby, where things could completely do a 180. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? I feel like the team on the day...
Like Wits are going to be watching this fixture.
You know what I mean? Not just as a Kaizer Chiefs fan, I have every... Don't.
Did you move away from me when I was
Yeah, I actually did a little bit. I shifted away. But that's okay. Man. It's all friendly in sport. I feel like there is every chance that Kaizer Chiefs could turn it around. Do you believe in the spirit of the Soweto Derby? I feel like there is a spiritual sense to it.
Definitely, but you have to keep in mind that Chiefs have actually struggled in recent years against Pirates. I think the last time they won was when Stuart Baxter was the coach.
I see the all black you're wearing, Carl.
Wow, eh?
So 10 games they haven't beaten Pirates. So that says something. And I think Pirates, their stability, you know, under Coach Mishu and Rulani, I think there's a good feeling around the camp. Yes, they've missed out on a cup this season in the final, but there's still a good feeling. They know what they're doing. Their squad is settled. And they're challenging for the league and challenging for a Champions League a title as well.
And there's also something like 13 debutants possibly to make it on the field from both teams. So players experiencing it for the first time, which is magic. Just very quickly, is Liverpool's season imploding as we speak? And if you disagree with me or hate me, you can phone in 021-430-9881.
I actually want to make a public service announcement to all football fans that Liverpool fans, please do not stress. They're not imploding. They're on course to have their biggest points haul of the season. Yes, they've slipped up once or twice, but there's still, I'd say, 15, 16 games of the season. So people need to calm down. Fans are too extreme. So they level on points. Liverpool have a game in hand. So if they beat Bournemouth and Chelsea beat City, you know, it's still the same.
What are the chances, man?
Hazard's looking to make a massive statement with these looming exits.
Just increase that price tag, man.
That might just happen. I love how the graphics team is just like, when you said the word Liverpool, they popped up this massive
bam.
We've spoken to, you know, whatever lengths about Arsenal. Nobody's ever popped up, you know, thanks, guys. We know where you are. How dare you, Roberto Firmino. Go away with that big smile of yours.
Man, they need it. They've walked a long journey, man.
Somebody send me his dentist's number.
For us to be in the kitchen where it's a lot less... It's very chilled.
It's chilled here.
And the nice thing is we're going to be making a recipe that is going to be a summertime favorite. It might look like an ice popsicle, but it is actually a marshmallow rice crispy treat.
Yes.
And of course made with our star ingredient, Super-M. And the kids are going to love it too.
The kids are going to love it as well. So we got our strawberry flavored Super-M. So of course you can use whatever flavor you get. There's the cream soda one.
Ooh, I love
the chocolate one is nice, the banana, whatever you want. Okay. So what we've done is, so we have marshmallows on a double boiler.
Lovely.
Or Bain Marie if you want to be fancy.
Okay.
So then you can pink ones and white ones and whatnot, and you get that. It's all nice and squishy up, and so you'll see it nice and melted. Then we have our, let's get Super M first.
Are we going to put the Super M?
Yes. Half a cup of Super M goes in there.
Alrighty.
Just half a cup. But the recipe will show exactly what you need to do. The keyword is treat. SMS that to 33728. All right, just like that. Let's give it a bit of a mix.
Mix it up.
There we go.
And I think this is also a great recipe that you can maybe, you know, just incorporate the young ones in.
Absolutely.
Make them feel like they're involved. they can see how you make it. And marshmallows are always fun as well.
Marshmallows are always fun. There we go. You can see it just loosened up a little bit because we have our marshmallows. It's been standing just a little bit. It's getting in there.
It's like bubble gum.
You know what? It's marshmallows, eh? It's a sticky, good mess, and we love it.
We love it.
There we go. So now that you get it nicely incorporated, just like that, we have our Rice Krispies.
Yay!
But lach, yay?
Nee, giggle my net. Kan ik je lach, nee?
Yeah, kan lach, it's fine.
There we go.
So our Rice Krispies goes in there. So basically, it's like your Rice Krispie treat, like you've mentioned as well.
Yeah.
So we're going to get that mixed nicely.
And oh, it looks so gooey and gummy and lovely.
And of course, the Super M flavor in there is going to really take it up a notch as well for you.
Nice.
So you see, it's quite a wettish mixture.
And I think it needs to be wettish because we're going to pop it into these popsicle molds here.
Exactly.
And if it's too stodgy, if it doesn't, you know, then it's going to struggle to get into the actual mold.
Okay, cool. Do you think that's good enough?
You. I think it's perfect.
You think that's good enough?
Here's a spoon.
Thank you very much. Let's get it into these molds. So normal ice lolly molds, and that goes straight in there. Let's get it in there. You can see. Bam.
Lovely.
Just like that.
Nice.
Sure, this does take a little bit of concentration.
I don't think you have to make all of them right now.
No, I'll just make one.
Okay.
I'll just make one, but it needs to be a good one. The keyword is treat. SMS that to 33728. That's treat to 33728 if you want to get your hands on the recipe. There we go, just like this. And now you fill up the rest, pop it in the freezer, and then when it comes out, it looks like this. And then you have white chocolate on standby. And you're going to pop
as it one
in
does.
As one does. As one does, you turn it around, you let it run a little bit, and now obviously because it's frozen, the white chocolate will set, and you have a beautiful lolly just like that.
Beautiful, and I think you can pop it into the fridge again so that the white chocolate sets.
You can, but I mean, then... by the time you take it out, I mean, obviously the white chocolate you do just before serving, it's going to be frozen, so the white chocolate will set very quickly, and you can serve as is.
Exactly, and then when you eat this, just wash it down with a different flavor, and life is good. It's just
get
amazing.
In there, man.
Treat to 33728. We'll gladly send you the link to the recipe and the ingredients list, and you could be making these delicious marshmallow puffed rice treats yourself. Mm,
I think you just sold it.
Take a moment between the madness to just chill with Super M, made with love by Clover.
Oh, that looks so yum. We're going to take a break right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso. After the break, we're talking golf. But it's not just golf. It's not another day chasing balls. It's golf with the president. Yes.
Yes. Okay. And then, of course, we're also going to get to know our performer, Patti Monroe, a little bit better. She's been on the music scene since 2015 and just going from strength to strength. Yeah. Are you okay around the golf?
Golf with the president.
Okay.
Clover Crush, 100% pure fruit juice packed with vitamins and no added sugar. Crush, your daily dose of goodness. Now also available in Long Life.
Live with love by Clover.
Sipping on them whiskey sours. Today I got it.
You are live with Espresso, wherever your allegiances lie. We know that this is a massive weekend, certainly in the world of football. Soweto derby time at the FNB Stadium tomorrow. Pirates certainly holding sway over Chiefs at the moment and under a fair bit of pressure. We know this. It's been a bit of a tough season. Then, of course, in the Premier League, a little further afield,
For the first time since December last year, Liverpool had been knocked off the top spot. But we, of course, open the lines to you, 0214309881. You are the most important voice in the mix here. Let's hear what Owen has to say this morning. A very good morning, Owen.
Good morning, Glenn. How are you?
I'm excited. I'm so excited, yeah. Man. I've just seen a Liverpool logo pop up on our screen. So I'm assuming maybe that you're a Liverpool fan. What you got to say, buddy?
Look, the thing is this, we have to stay on top of the league. And the thing is this, that my prediction is 2-1.
2-1. How do you arrive at this prediction, my friend? Just put it into context for us. Where is Liverpool? Are you feeling nervous? We know it's been a long time for Liverpool fans. Put the season into perspective for us.
Well, look, we don't have to be nervous about that because the thing is that we've been there once, and what is the chance of being there again? You see, the world can see that Liverpool is playing one of the top games now. People like Salah and Firmino, I mean, it's very, very good forwards that they got. See? And so the world can see that, but we are really going that way.
Okay, so I think Owen is anticipating Liverpool getting back, and it won't take a lot for them to get back to the top of the table. Thank you so much for weighing in, Owen. All the best of luck, buddy. Never forget, you never walk alone. Certainly not when Carl Lewis is in the studio, apparently. Are other teams possibly getting Jurgen Klopp's number at this stage? When we saw what Bournemouth were able to do against Chelsea and absolutely pick them apart, there are very few minnow teams left. The middle of the table in the Premier League at the moment is insanely strong. What Eddie Howe has been able to do in that club is amazing. Will we see a repeat of what happened against Chelsea, or do you think the little wobble that Liverpool have experienced is now done and dusted?
I think this is actually the perfect game for Liverpool to get back to winning ways. The reason I say that is because I love Eddie Howe and I respect him because, you know, they aren't the biggest team, but they always play the football. They always stick to their style, and their style is quite open, keep the ball on the carpet. So I think for Liverpool, with their frontmen, their pacemen, they can expose the gaps in between their midfield and defence. So that's why I think it's the perfect game for Liverpool to maybe bang in 2 goals.
I think it was West Ham was their last game where they looked a little bit shaky. They were playing quite zonal in their defence, which is the individuals, Van Dijk, these guys have stood out as individual powerhouses in defence. But every team needs to go through this. How can you win a title without a bit of a challenge there? The flip side of that coin, of course, a massive matchup for Man City up against Chelsea. A resurgent Chelsea looked phenomenal against Huddersfield. City maybe look like the better team again. Is this going to be a game of tennis up until the end of the season? Do you think that the team playing second is going to have the pressure?
This is a fascinating fixture because I know these two managers are very intense about their tactics and the way they think about the game. And I know they have a lot of mutual respect for each other. So I think fans should watch out for the tactical battle there. You know, once again, two teams that love carpet football. but we must remember that Chelsea actually beat City earlier this season. 2-0, I think, at Stamford Bridge. So they might just have a chance against City. But we must forget that City's or scores 2 or more times at the Etihad. I think 13 times this season.
Yeah, no, their goal difference is insanely good there. Yeah. Just the last thing I'm going to ask you, you've got 3 seconds to be able to do it, a score for the Soweto derby.
2-1 Pirates, just like the last two fixtures this season.
That's why he came in black. We have confirmed it. You can let us know on all of our social media platforms how you're feeling about the derby action the weekend. Will Kaizer Chiefs find a way back? Can they beat the Buccaneers?
I'm pretty sure they'll manage it. I'm a Kosi for life. Come on, boys, let's make it happen. Now, every year since 1996, the president of the country has hosted the annual presidential golf tournament. Now, the event is aimed at promoting social corporate investments in South Africa, as well as bringing together business and government officials to find ways that the two entities can better empower the disempowered. And this morning, I'm joined by Deputy Minister for Public Service and Administration, Dr. Kanapilani Majake, to tell us a bit more about the PGC. A very good morning to you, Deputy Minister.
Good morning, Katleho.
Have you managed
good morning to the viewers.
Have you managed to find some rest since last night? It must have been a very, very busy night after the sauna.
I've tried to. Yes, just quite a hectic night, but I'm here.
I can imagine. Mm. But let's shift our focus to the Presidential Golf Challenge. And why exactly this event is so important, such that it's been held every single year since 96?
This is an annual charitable event that's actually always hosted by sitting presidents with a view of raising funds to actually promote the well-being of various areas where there is need. We know that as government, we actually provide services, but there could be areas where there are gaps, and such gaps are normally filled by efforts of this nature.
Absolutely. And it's also, I guess, a fun day in general. I mean, I was fortunate enough to attend last year and to see the president take his first swing off the tee box, and quite an impressive swing he had. But
yes.
Tell me about the individuals that are gathered. Who attends the PGC?
The Presidential Golf Challenge normally is attended by people from business. Of course, we want the money, and this is why we'll have business coming and participating. Mm-hmm. We'll have ministers, deputy ministers. We'll have members of parliament and just general South Africans that are actually interested in being part of the event.
Yeah. Mm. And tell me about some of the positive stories that have come out of the proceeds of the PGC that have gone into these charitable works all these years. Perhaps a few highlights.
The Presidential Golf Challenge actually started during the time of President Mbeki, I think 1996. And whenever money is actually raised, it actually goes into programs that mostly during their time was actually assisting in terms of really looking at the needs of children in schools, providing bursaries, and providing to families that are needy. Yeah. And with this one of President Cyril Ramaphosa, focus will be on the Cyril Ramaphosa Foundation. Mm-hmm. And the Cyril Ramaphosa Foundation has got a number of programs. They've got the Tari program, they've got the Black Umbrellas, they've got Adopt a School program. So this one, focus will be on the Adopt a School program, mm-hmm. Which is a program that actually just focuses on school-going children and the school and the school infrastructure. Mm-hmm. And the intention this time is really to look at promotion of sanitation within schools, mm-hmm. water and sanitation. And I'm sure you know of a case of a child that actually fell in the pit latrine. It really touched the heart of the president and the President Cyril Ramaphosa Foundation, to the extent that with the money that is raised, we'll actually go around looking for schools that are actually really lacking in this regard and really improving the infrastructure to be sure that South African children, when they go to school, they don't have to come back there because of a pit latrine.
And I do remember the president referring to that incident yesterday in his State of the Nation address.
Yes.
But here is the day now, and we hope that there'll be millions and millions and millions that flow in from business that are going to be supporting the president's chosen charity. Have there been some personal highlights for you in the past years at the Presidential Golf Challenge?
I have really not been attending quite a number of them. Mm-hmm. this time, I'm here because my department, Department of Public Service and Administration, mm-hmm. is the one that normally hosts this Presidential Golf Challenge. Mm-hmm. So it's a beginning for me in a way. Yes. But of course, with golf, I do play golf even if I don't have a handicap.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic.
Maybe I might actually try to play today. I don't know, just watch the space.
I was about to ask whether we might see some action from you, because you've got the cap on, mm-hmm. the gear is looking right.
Yes.
Have you got your golf boots in the car
waiting? My golf bag is in the car, yes, and from here we'll be really get into the golf course.
Deputy Minister Pilani Majake, thank you very much for joining us. Good luck. Hopefully the weather plays along. It's a little bit misty, but hopefully the cool conditions will continue, just clearing up a little bit to make for a wonderful Presidential Golf Challenge. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Katlego, and thanks to the listeners.
Yeah, and thank you very much.
To the viewers.
Yeah, to the viewers, and good luck to everyone playing out there. I'm sure there'll be a hashtag PGC or hashtag Presidential Golf Challenge that'll be going on out there so that we can follow in all of the action.
Well, not only is it a busy day ahead, but a busy weekend. We now connect with the 5FM team. Roger Good, Shireshni Ryder, Ms. Cosmo, and Robbie Cruz. Are you guys there? Good morning.
Morning, Zoe. How you doing?
Hey, no complaints my side. Have you guys got a busy weekend ahead?
We do. Just before we kick it off, we have to say all hail Lucian. Happy birthday, Lucian.
Of course it is. I feel like Lucian needs to come in here because he's very excited. Thank you for that.
Beautiful, beautiful.
He's on camera right now.
Oh, he's looking good. He's looking hot, honey. Yeah.
Awesome. Listen, Lucian will definitely be celebrating the whole weekend, his birthday.
All right. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. I was putting his run up here in Johannesburg. First up, we got Deep Town Josie featuring Julian Gomes and Sean Monick. They are back once again, one of the greatest DJ producers on the planet. As the new year begins and the calendar year counts increments by one, Deep Town Josie is proud to present the second event of 2019 featuring one of our favorite DJ producers, Julian Gomes and Sean Monick. Check them out Saturday, 9 February from 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Nice sundowner vibes into the evening. $80 will get you in. That's first up.
Awesome.
Second position, staying in Johannesburg, Sounds Wild, featuring Bonaboo. That's happening at Fox Junction event venue. They've had numerous requests from fans. Bonobo will be headlining Sounds Wild Festival with a highly anticipated DJ set featuring Bonobo. We got... Two stages, that's what they're featuring from 8 in the evening at Fox Junction, 14 Alexander Street, Fariersdorp, Johannesburg. And finally, we're staying in Joburg this weekend. It's a big weekend in Joburg. Kaizer Chiefs versus Orlando Pirates at the FNB Stadium. The Soweto Derby is a soccer rivalry between Premier Soccer League Kaizer Chiefs and Orlando Pirates. It is considered one of the best and most fiercely contested matches in African football. Can we have a score prediction, coach? What do you say?
I'm gonna go 2-1.
Kaizer Chiefs, Orlando Pirates.
Well, yeah, there you have it.
I don't know which team to pick.
Yep, close to pick, I guess.
What's your score prediction?
We're gonna go 2-1. 2-1.
2-1. Which team?
I'm gonna say something clever, Robbie.
Oh, well, listen, Pirates. Seems like a busy and super exciting weekend in Johannesburg. Well, here in Cape Town, there's something that's kicked off and established in 2012. It is the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival, and it's gained international recognition for being one of the most relevant, forward-thinking, and, of course, inclusive events on Africa's festival calendar. It's taking place at the Castle of Good Hope. It starts on Saturday the 12th, and tickets start at $350. What is that sound? Is it a donkey? Okay, well, buy a donkey and you'll learn. That was the 5 of M team.
Give a cricket.
That was the 5 of M team connecting with us, giving us their pick of the weekend. Of course, we also gave them ours. They gave us some donkey sounds in between. I do not hate you guys. I promise I could hear that. That is Roger Good and his team. Well, don't go anywhere. We still have a lot coming up for you on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Then can I sound check my other song, please?
Sipping on them whiskey sours. Today I got an extra hour.
Yeah, I like it. I think
puffing on them jobs.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back. You're tuned into your Feel Good Breakfast Show Express, the right show on SABC3. It's a Friday, and yay, we are certainly feeling that weekend vibes, and I do hope that you as well. Right now, let's head on over to the theatre. Now, listen to this. Can you imagine a story where the paths of beloved fairy tale characters like Cinderella, Rapunzel, Prince Charming, the giant killer Jack become so intertwined and complex that would no longer be a children's story?
Wow, well, that is what the world is becoming fully realized in, with a musical theatre production that is currently playing at Cape Town's Theatre on the Bay. Sounds cool.
Very cool.
When venturing into the woods, it can be considered foreboding, mysterious, sometimes just a little bit creepy, but it's also the perfect place to see some of your favorite fairy tale characters collide in a battle of desire and destiny. And that is exactly what you can expect at Theatre on the Bay in their brand new production, Into the Woods.
Most people may know this adult musical, which features music and lyrics written by legendary composer Stephen Sondheim from the 2014 film adaptation. But the story itself is relatively young in comparison to the source materials that inspired it.
Stephen Sondheim has given us a totally new look at a bunch of very well-known and very well-loved fairy tale characters, but he spins them on their head and gives us a very modern universe in which they're operating. We meet Rapunzel, Cinderella, Jack and the Beanstalk, Red Riding Hood, a witch, and each of them thinks that they want something desperately, and they get it. A lot of musicals require one or two stars and then an ensemble cast that sort of fills in the gaps with a chorus. In this production, it's absolutely imperative that all 15 cast members are stars in their own right, because each of them carries a very important part of the narrative.
The parts of these well-known and usually sympathetic characters all intersect as they go into the deep, dark woods on separate quests, with sometimes amusing and often unexpected results.
Hello, cast of Into the Woods. Listen, I can't wait to see this production, but talk to me about these iconic historic characters that you are playing in this almost like a modern setup. Does it change the way in which you view these characters yourself?
They're all based on the real characters. They're rooted in the real thing. But Stephen Sondheim takes it even further and extrapolates the main tale, and you see beyond the happy ending.
Even though this is all fairy tales, it's grounded in reality and it's not aimed at kids. This is something that everyone connects to. There's so many different themes that I don't think there's a single person in the audience who won't resonate with that.
There are elements which are really surprising. Your reaction to the story then is quite interesting, because it's playing on things that you know and love, and I think that's a really lovely part of the story.
Now, of course, this is a musical, and the music plays a very big part of this production. And from what I understand, the lyrics are very clever and witty. How does that help you portray your specific character?
And that's what makes it so exciting as a performer, because every single time you either are performing it or you're listening backstage to somebody else, you're like, oh, I haven't heard that before. And it's
that's what she's saying.
Yeah, I'm like, oh my gosh, she's so clever. Which is so exciting. It's like so colorful and complex. It's incredible.
The scope and the range of the complexity of his compositions are just so engaging to the ear to listen to, just because there's so much in the music, you know, so I really enjoy.
When approaching the design for Into the Woods, we were aware that the show works in two very clear halves. The first half is a joyous musical mashup of traditional fairy tales. It's gloriously witty, it's laugh out loud funny, and incredibly entertaining. And for all of those reasons, we've created a very lush, typical fairy tale forest that you would expect to find in the illustrations of any classic compilation of fairy tales. The second half is much deeper, it's much more poignant and thought-provoking, and for that we have stripped away the forest and created a more bare and deconstructed look.
What an incredible production, so well put together, Into the Woods at Theatre on the Bay. Your favourite fairy tale characters like you've never seen them before. Get down to the Theatre on the Bay and experience a night out of true magic. You will not be sorry.
Alrighty, alrighty, it's a Friday morning, and as you can see, we are in very, very good company with one of our favorite Malachis here. Yeah. Patty Monroe in the studio! Yeah. Yes! Neighbors, celebrate! Look, look
at your windows. Stand up, Yella.
It's so great to have you back.
Oh my word, I'm so...
Yes, take it all in. Take it all in.
It's so good to be here. Thanks for having me, guys.
Where you been?
Thank you.
Where you been all our lives? You got fans all around. Where you been all our lives? You were telling me earlier on that.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, new music. It's New Music Friday. Dropping brand new single, Fill Your Cup, which we will hear a little bit later on in the show. So we're very excited about that. But take us pre-Fill Your Cup, when the cup was empty.
When the cup was empty, or no, I don't want to say when the cup was empty. I'd rather say when the cup wasn't as full.
Yeah, half full.
As full as it is now, because now it's flowing over.
Yes.
Yes, the glow.
Yeah.
This ain't no highlight, this is real life.
What have you been up to over the past couple of months? Because you've been working intensely.
The past couple of months, I took some time out for myself.
What?
Some just like a reflective period, a hibernation.
Yeah.
Just to like refresh, re-energize, re-strategize, and just breathe.
Yeah, I
feel that's so important.
A little cocoon period so that you could
basically
bring out your butterfly.
So I can now shine your light.
Shine your and obviously it's worked out well because you've come out feeling super refreshed and fill your cup. Like I said, we're going to hear it later on, but tell me about the creative process and the inspiration behind the song.
So the inspiration behind the song, it started off like when you hear it's, you don't know if I'm talking about a man or if I'm talking about the person that I look at when I look into the mirror.
Okay.
So it's a play on that. And I feel like, because that's what it is for me, a woman in life, like we have to now get a man, we have to get a husband, take a husband, become a wife, become a mother. But what about like ourselves? Yeah. We also have to stay true to who we are and... Most importantly, it's basically just, it's about a creative woman, someone who inspires people, someone who just brings so much warmth, so much light. I don't like to talk too much on my
songs.
I know, you want
the music to speak, and it will be speaking for itself at the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival that's happening in Castle of Good Hope.
Oh, snap, are you ready?
Okay, on the 9th of February. I'm ready, okay, I'm ready. On the 9th of February between 12 to late, basically.
Yeah.
Get your tickets, you'll be able to see the likes of Patty Monroe on stage, but fortunately for you, she is live, large, in charge, looking so Persian!
Hey, looking Persian!
On your feel-good breakfast show on this Friday, we're gonna take a break, we'll be back. Neighbors, everybody around town, we're gonna celebrate! Patty Monroe is here! Come on now!
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Family, welcome back to it. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show Espresso right here on SABC3. Hope you're getting that Feel Good Friday vibe in. It's time to check in with the news with Leanne.
Thank you so much, Thabiso. In the national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa announced in his State of the Nation address in Parliament in Cape Town last night that the country would head for the polls in the general election on the 8th of May. He also announced that debt-laden Eskom would be split into three parts. The French oil giant Total yesterday announced that it had made a significant natural gas discovery about 180 kilometers off the coast in Mossel Bay. The so-called Brilpadda find is estimated at about 1 billion barrels. On the international front, heads of state and government representatives are gathering in Ethiopia this week for a meeting of the African Union. The meeting's main focus will be on the refugee crisis. The diplomatic row between France and Italy yesterday deepened, with France complaining of unfounded attacks and outlandish claims by Italian leaders. France recalled its ambassador to Italy for talks, saying the situation was unprecedented since World War II. And then finally, thinking on your feet, remaining calm under pressure, and applying months of training and practice. This is what truck driver, or rather truck technician, Miles Swanepoel had to do to beat 64 other technicians from 32 participating countries across the world in the recent World Technical Competition in Japan. Swanepoel ended in fourth place overall in the individual Grand Prix commercial vehicle division of the competition. The top three spots went to technicians from Japan, Indonesia, and Australia, respectively. But we want to say a big well done to Miles. South Africans are indeed making the world take notice in all fronts. Congratulations. Time for us to take another look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here's Graham Richards.
Yep, we're going to keep on trucking this weekend. Eight Premier League fixtures and counting over the weekend. But it will be Liverpool and Bournemouth. I think that everyone's watching. If Liverpool comes out with anything more than a loss, they'll be back on top of that title race. Staying with football, tomorrow evening, the big one, Soweto Derby time, takes place between obviously Orlando Pirates and Kaizer Chiefs at the FNB Stadium. Historically, the match has been won by Chiefs at a narrow 25-21, but Pirates have certainly held sway in recent times. In rugby, Six Nations continues this weekend with three upcoming fixtures. Saturday, we'll see Scotland take on the wounded beast that is Ireland, and Italy face off against Wales. Then Sunday, another massive one. Rugby powerhouses England and France resume their age-old rivalry. Then in cricket, the Proteas will have a little time to rest on their laurels after this past weekend's T20, or this past week's T20 victory, to see a clean sweep in their series against Pakistan. Sri Lanka's national cricket team makes its way to Mzansi shores this coming Wednesday. And historically, South Africa have always fared well against the Lions, certainly better than Pakistan. So it bodes well for the tour. And that's where we leave our sport for now. Thank you, G. Let's take a look at your 7 o'clock traffic. Starting off in Gauteng in Bedford View, where there has been an accident on the N3 northbound after Linksville Road, obstructing two lanes. Please do approach that area with caution. Off to the Western Cape and Observatory on the N2 outbound, there has been a multi-vehicle accident after Nelson Mandela Boulevard. The left lane is currently blocked and causing delays, so please do approach that with caution as well. We'll be back with another report on your traffic at 7:30.
Don't fear the flu. Boost your immune system with Everflu C Immune Booster by Pharmadynamics. Effective, affordable healthcare.
Thank you, Thabiso. Well, time for us to take a look at those beautiful sunrise photos coming through. We received this one from Buddha, who sent us this amazing sunrise picture from Davyton. Buddha, today you can expect partly cloudy conditions and some thunderstorms in the afternoon, reaching a maximum of 27 degrees Celsius. Well, on that note, let's take a look at the rest of the temperatures. In Polokwane, your minimum for today is 15, your maximum 29. Mbombela, 17, with a high of 30. Thunder showers is expected in Pretoria with a high of 29. Johannesburg, 17, reaching a high of 27. Partly cloudy conditions in Mahikeng, 18, with a high of 30. Klerksdorp, 18, reaching a high of 31. Kimberley, your low is 20, your high 32. If you're in Bloemfontein, 18, 31 can be expected. Richards Bay, 23, with a high of 32. Pietermaritzburg, partly cloudy with a low of 18 and a high of 36. Durban 24 with a high of 31, Mthatha 19 reaching a high of 38, partly cloudy conditions in East London today, 20 with a high of 33. Sunny in Cradock with a high of 39, Port Elizabeth 19 reaching a high of 28, partly cloudy conditions in George today, your high is 26, Sutherland 18 reaching a high of 32. In the Mother City, expect cloudy conditions, partly cloudy conditions with a high of 25. Worcester, sunny with a low of 17, a high of 36. Springbok, 19, 29. And Upington, a low of 22 with a high of 32 degrees Celsius. If you have a beautiful sunrise photo that you'd love to share with us, feel free to do so on the Expresso Facebook page. But it's now that time of the morning for us to wish you a happy birthday.
Happy birthday, a very happy birthday to you.
Yes, 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 yes.
Oh, goodness.
People are birthdaying.
People are birthdaying. Indeed, a lot of birthdays taking place. Before we get into some of your birthdays, let's take a look at some of the big names as well celebrating their birthday today. Of course, cinema legend James Dean. He was born on the 8th of February, 1931. Yeah. And of course, also sharing his birthday is another legend in cinema, composer John Williams, who created some of the most iconic musical pieces in cinematic history, including the theme songs for Jaws, Harry Potter, even Jurassic Park. And I really think our favorite films would be very, very different without him. So happy birthday to them. Now, let's see who else celebrates their birthdays today. Look at that.
Let's start with you, our viewers at home now, the silliness. So first up, we'd like to give a massive birthday shout out to Chanel.
Ooh, hello, Chanel.
Geisha looking girl.
Yeah.
Stunning.
Chanel, gorgeous. And then Asta's husband, who shall go nameless, would like to wish her a very happy birthday today as well. Asta, give your hubby a big hug and a kiss.
Yes, definitely. While Dylan is also celebrating his birthday today, Dylan is, we want to say happy birthday and have an absolutely amazing one.
Yep.
Is that, isn't it?
That's a cop.
Carpe diem.
Carpe diem.
Wow, that is one beautiful looking fish. And then also we'd like to wish to Hale a very happy birthday today. Yes. Swag
up, dog? What's up,
swag.
Happy birthday, Hale.
And then I think a birthday bigger than James Dean, birthday. Lucian Albertine.
Lucian Albertine.
Celebrating his birthday today. Lucian, I'd like to wish you a very happy birthday, my man. I think things would definitely not be the same without you.
Yeah, I know.
Brilliant, man. Have yourself a beautiful birthday. We're going to be celebrating with you.
We love you, man.
Yeah, we do love you, dude.
Yeah.
And Megan, another member from the Expressive family, is also celebrating her birthday. Look at that, birthday.
We've also got Guff over here. We'd like to give a birthday shout out to Guff, who's celebrating his birthday tomorrow. So cool. And the cruise pants, are they called cruise pants? The thing?
What are you?
I think you look very suave. Yeah, so cool.
What do you call those things again?
Also, we'd also like to give a birthday shout out to Bailey.
Grace Banda.
Okay, well, Bailey Gray Pillay is also celebrating a second birthday that's happening tomorrow on Saturday.
Happy birthday to each and every one of you celebrating your birthdays. It's so amazing to be celebrating it with you as well. But if you would like to celebrate your birthday with us here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, you can just send us a picture and your dedication to birthdays at Cordova.tv. And we'll have some cake and sparkles on your behalf. And we'll throw in some balloons as well. Why not? Get those emails in, birthdays at Cordova.tv. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Listen, it's a Friday. We're about to give you that Fri-yay feeling because Patty Monroe be the business right now. Here she is.
The business.
Whew, whiskey sours. Let's go. Okay.
Sipping on them whiskey sours. Today I got an extra hour. Puffing on them dry flowers. Ooh, I got all my superpowers. flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today. Flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today. And it's a force of habit, how I'm about my carrots. And I just wanna breathe, they just wanna savage. Head up in the clouds, on that loud, loud. Surfing to the crowds of a sheep in a deep sleep. A TLC creep, today I conquer the beast I defeat. It ain't no secret, if I said it, I mean it. You hit, you can keep it. I won't judge you, best believe it. Sipping on them whiskey sours. Today I got an extra hour. Puffing on them jar flowers. Ooh, I got all my superpowers. Flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today. Flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today. Little Lotus girl, you're beautiful. Please know your worth. You're beautiful. Little Lotus girl, you're beautiful. Please know your worth. You're beautiful. Sipping on them whiskey sours. Today I got an extra hour. Puffing on them jar flowers. Ooh, I got all my superpowers. Flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today. Flying through time, got me feeling some type of way. Namaste, I'ma get my guap today.
Show, getting us into that Friday feeling, Friday mood. Again. We are ready for it. You can catch her performing at the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival.
The one and only, guys. You don't want to miss it. You really don't want to miss it.
9th of Feb. That's tomorrow.
No, it's tomorrow.
That's tomorrow. What time are you on stage?
Hop us four. Come the early, guys. Come.
Excellent. Oh. I feel like you're going to give all the energy. The performance is going to be absolutely amazing. In the meantime, link up with us and let us know what you thought about this performance, and we'll have more from Miss Patty Monroe later on. Brand new single, brand new music.
Mm. One more time for Patty Monroe.
Yes. Absolutely incredible. I love her voice. I love her stage presence. I love everything.
Nah, man, she's brilliant. And we feel like a croissant and a coffee to go with that performance.
Ooh, yes,
for
please.
Sure. Princess, please.
I need a croissant to wash down this coffee. Thanks, girl.
Listen, coming up after the break, we're going to be sitting down with our tech expert, Tiennes. He's here. We're talking about WhatsApp deleting 2 million accounts. What? 2 million again? I don't know. Hopefully it's not one of ours. Okay, we'll
check
it out.
Next level stuff. Talking about next level, we are going to be exploring, well, actually not we, but Graham is the perfect Valentine's Day hotel, just for a little bit of something, something.
You know, it's the month of love.
You know it.
We'll be back
straight
after the
take
break.
Take notes.
Enjoy a moment in between with MacCafe. See you after the break.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
A very good morning to you. Welcome back. Sorry, Tubbsy. I just jumped in there.
Yeah, you did. You almost spilled your coffee on your light suit. Well.
It's because this princess gave me some of her best grind, and it's so cool.
Ah, princess with the good beans.
You know what I mean?
Right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Well, look, it's time for, how is that even a thing? We know that the world is filled with lots of crazy conspiracy theories, like the Earth or Flat Earth Society, who believe that the Earth actually is flat and not round, and people who believe that the moon landings were actually faked, right? So right now we're taking a look at three of those kind of stories that have us going,
tell you what,
Should we get you some water?
This cup I'm having might just prove my story that I have, but that's a story that we'll visit in a second.
Okay, do you want to take a sip of your coffee?
Yeah, yeah, thank you for the grind.
Sorry, I didn't say that.
I can't believe it. You just like completely had me do that just for that. Okay.
It's okay. We get evens.
Okay, well, let's focus our attention on the royals. There's always been, you know, an air of mystery surrounding the royal families, and many wild theories have emerged over the years, especially since Princess Diana's fatal car accident being orchestrated by the government. But sure, one theory definitely takes the cake, or should we say the flesh. Mm-hmm. Now, the theory is the Queen of England has managed to stay so energetic and lively for so many years because she eats human flesh. Guys, that is the theory. It started in 1973 when an article by a writer named Hubert Humdinger, he described the Queen as packed with more energy than the sun, and that, I'm quoting, she must eat human flesh to be so vivacious. Now, then a couple of years ago, a story emerged of an electrician who was given permission to fix electrical problems in Windsor Castle's kitchen, only to find frozen human body parts in the freezer.
Well, let me just say, the guy's surname is Humdinger, so
well,
I don't know how much you can believe.
Well, if there's no photos to prove it, just saying.
There we go.
Yeah.
Anyway, listen to this story.
Okay, that's so weird.
Now, you know when you watch airplanes fly out in the air, there's like this white cloud-like trail that's left behind them. So that's called contrails, and they're caused by airplanes' exhaust mixing with the atmosphere, some kind of low pressure and temperatures. But that's not what the CIA wants us to think, according to a conspiracy theorist or community called chemtrails. They believe that it's actually the government trying to poison us.
Oh, okay? Wow.
Check this out. So the belief is that what they're trying to achieve, there's a lot of different things by spraying chemicals over us, and they could be trying to control the weather, they could be trying to control the population through sterilization, or even controlling our minds. And this conspiracy theory has become so popular that even celebrities got on board, including Kylie Jenner and Prince, who admitted his concerns about this on a live TV show.
The secret spraying programs. People are taking out to protest for this. Well, this is insane.
Guys,
well,
listen, your car's exhaust leaves fumes. The sky is going to do the
same. But what if the stuff they're spraying in the air has extra chemical X? Mm.
Then it would be suspicious if it flew consistently over everyone.
It dissipates in the air. Can you disprove it?
Wow.
Okay, listen, if you're out there finding any of these kind of stories that have you thinking, like, how is that even a thing? Why don't you share them with us on social media using the hashtag
ExpressiveShow.
I forgot my mask.
Little mask, yeah. Hey, secret spraying programs. How is that even a thing? I don't know. Anyways, so we are into the month of love.
We are?
We are, dude. It's time to ramp up the romance a little bit. And if you're looking for a little bit of a romantic getaway, we've got you sorted this morning.
Yep, I am going to go out there and do this on your behalf because I care that much about your union. Now, I discovered, obviously, we know that the Wineland Stellenbosch, one of the most romantic places on earth. But let's get to the nitty gritty here and discover some activities that you guys can do as a shared experience. And of course, using the Protea Hotel by Marriott in Stellenbosch as a home base, perfect springboard.
For me, the perfect vacation is pretty much anywhere with a loved one. So around this very romantic time of the year, close to Valentine's Day, I thought I would inspire you to get out there, love life and each other a little bit more. Play Cupid, if you will. When it comes to couples getaways, Stellenbosch is the place to be, with these majestic views, with fun food and adventure right at your doorstep. All that's left is to explore. think my favorite thing about Stellenbosch is the fact that it's close enough to Cape Town to get away relatively quickly, easily, inexpensively, but it's far enough away to feel like you are getting away. Obviously, the setting is unmatched. You're in the winelands, but you've also got right on your doorstep some of the best restaurants. And having a base camp like Protea Hotel by Marriott in Stellenbosch gives you the perfect kind of footing to be able to set foot out on all kinds of adventures. You can also then go home to a beautiful home away from home in the form of the Protea Hotel by Marriott in Stellenbosch. The staff are amazing, and it really is this incredibly homely feeling, but also with a touch of class. It's going to make you feel special. This is the ideal romantic getaway setting because, I mean, just look around you. If you want to cut out all the clutter, de-stress, and really give yourselves an opportunity to reconnect, you've got to get out into nature. But if you want to take that shared experience to a whole new dimension, I'm going to test out doing a scooter in the Yonkerzoek Nature Reserve, and it looks spectacular. But are you ready?
Let's scoot.
Let's scoot. So I found the scooters experience something really unique, which is saying a lot because I get to experience a lot of these kinds of things, but this is something that was really easy to adopt. But this is something completely new. There's a bit of speed, there's a bit of adrenaline. It's a nice course that takes you through different levels of technicality, so to speak. It took me all of 5 minutes to kind of find my feet. And then you look up and you look around and you've got one of the most majestic mountain ranges I have ever seen. Yonkerzoek Nature Reserve is a truly remarkable and unique place, a place that I cannot wait to bring the special person in my life back to so that she can feel that same exhilaration. I reckon at the heart of every tradition is a meaningful experience, and Umsami Savunkel certainly fits that bill. A treasure trove of trinkets true to South Africa's heritage for almost over a century. In existence since 1904, some believe even earlier, for over 115 years, it has carried on the final tradition of old post trading. And I reckon you can find just about anything in Umsami's. This is incredible. It feels like being in a movie and getting a history lesson all at the same time. I think there might be a few products that were sold in the original store back in 1904. I have to admit, it is making me feel like a big kid all over again. It's awesome. Umsami's Savunkel is like a time capsule. There are things from a very bygone era, things that are old school, the kinds of fashions that we've lived through, just really is a taste of history in the here and now, something that is truly remarkable. And I don't think I've actually ever been into a store that has been in existence for 115 years. For tourists, if you're going to visit one place, that's it. Once you've indulged in the traditional flavors of one culture, another opens up and sends your taste buds into overdrive. It's no wonder we have such a deep appreciation and respect for cultural diversity. And it's amazing how a good meal can make you feel right at home. That's certainly the case here at Manouche. I am told serving the best Lebanese cuisine in the Western Cape, and I'm about to find out. Manouche is like the perfect balance of these massive plates of delicious food that I would imagine students would nosh and keep coming back for more, and this beautiful, delicate cuisine that would bring a very non-student crowd in to enjoy. From the flavors that you get to explore, from the oven that they've imported, from the family running the business, it really was a taste of Lebanon here in the winelands. That is unbelievable. What a mix. Oh, this is a treat. I love that style of eating. I love exploring cultures through food, and I really did get a taste of some of the best Lebanese food that I think I've ever been lucky enough to have. I think Cupid's job is done. It's clear that a Stelly's couple's getaway has got to be a cut above the rest. After a day jam-packed with fun, lots of food, adventure, all that's left is for me to recharge and do it all over again. And of course, take a breath to savor this. Wow.
I've suddenly got hungry again.
Okay.
I've got so hungry again. Manoush was awesome, but what a romantic
dude, it looks like you had a very romantic time by yourself.
I felt like a bit of a loser, but hopefully that's inspired you guys to go out there and experience something new with someone that you love.
Absolutely, man. But for the romantic offers across South Africa and beyond, just imagine the possibilities this Valentine's month at Protea Hotels by Marriott. So what you need to do is visit protea.marriott.com to make your booking. We suggest you do that because it does look like the ultimate romantic
Valentine's
getaway.
It's coming, man.
It's
unavoidable.
It's just there. Anyway, so we're going to be taking a very quick break. It's your Friday morning. It's so good to be hanging out with you. Stick around. You feel good breakfast show. It's a Friday morning, and you know what that song means. It's time to get your daily tech digest. I need to rewind.
Welcome
my brain.
To the deck here at Espresso.
Ah man,
buddy.
Wow. It's because of what's happening right now. The world is crumbling around us. Mm-hmm. WhatsApp is deleting 2 million accounts a month. Why is that happening, our friend in tech dearness?
Well, essentially, the whole world is being bombarded with the phenomenon we call fake news right now. So everywhere, people are not knowing, forwarding a lot of fake news stories that people think is true, and they just don't know any better. So what Facebook is trying to do through WhatsApp, obviously, and Google is also trying to do, is cut down on the spreading of this fake news, or just stories that aren't 100% accurate or portraying things in a certain way that just makes the opposite seem true, essentially. Yeah. So from deleting 2 million accounts a month, what they're trying to achieve is exactly that on WhatsApp. So by deleting accounts, they mean with machine learning algorithms, they actually see when people forward these stories, not knowing that it's fake, and then that gets flagged. And most of these accounts are actually bots just pinging messages and sending those things.
That's what I wanted to ask here, because I mean, am I wrong? I always assumed this was just a messaging platform, but clearly it is not, and it's being abused by companies. Is this the Facebook influence? Was WhatsApp always going to go this direction? You know, why is this so nefarious, I want to say, because it kind of feels like this is entering into our private space. You expect to find, fake news on Facebook, because it's a very open platform
it's
where people are posting
thing,
and sharing. WhatsApp feels personal, that it's a private closed loop. Am I completely wrong?
Supposed to be, yes. But remember that they have to monetize it somehow. So we don't pay to use WhatsApp, but You've got something like WhatsApp Business, where businesses can now use WhatsApp to interact with their customers. They pay for that service, and they have to monetize the platform. So that means that more APIs can be built that link into WhatsApp, and that's where all of these fake accounts are coming from.
Yeah.
So you mean Kat and I haven't made our millions out of Bitcoin?
None of us have.
According to the fake news that is going around.
Yo, can you believe that?
I know,
no,
man.
I don't know anything about people making millions of Bitcoin. Please, don't at me. I don't know anything about that. And Google is also using machine learning to block some 1 million spam messages, right? A day.
Yeah, yeah. It's millions and millions of spam messages a day. So you won't, hopefully, in the future, receive any emails from a Nigerian prince. Essentially, Gmail is trying to do.
I was about to reply to that.
So yeah, don't do that. So essentially, very much in the same way, they're using machine learning to identify these messages, because now we've got computers that can ping these out millions at a time they don't even have to know what your email address is. They can just run through every single combination of letters and numbers, and some people will get it because there's only a finite number of ways that you can arrange that. So it's the same thing where it's a bunch of bots just spamming messages, and people get defrauded that way.
Wowzers. Okay, that is what is happening in the world of tech. Thank you very much to Tennessee Janssen van Rensburg for keeping
us updated. Destroying our faith in humanity.
Well, that too. Let us know which stories have caught your attention, and of course, when you do so, share them with us on social media using hashtag ExpressoShow.
In your national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa announced in his State of the Nation address in Parliament in Cape Town last night that the country would head for the general polls in the general election on the 8th of May. He also announced that debt-laden Eskom would be split into three parts. The French oil giant Total yesterday announced that it had made a significant natural gas discovery about 180 kilometers off the coast in Mossel Bay. The so-called Brolpadda find is estimated at about 1 billion barrels. Heads of state and government representatives are gathering in Ethiopia this week for a meeting of the African Union. The meeting's main focus will be on the refugee crisis. The diplomatic row between France and Italy yesterday deepened, with France complaining of unfounded attacks and outlandish claims by Italian leaders. France recalled its ambassador to Italy for talks, saying the situation was unprecedented since World War II. And then finally, a 30-year-old security guard in Kaniso Taba bravely pulled bedridden patients from a burning ward at a hospital in KwaZulu-Natal before collapsing due to smoke inhalation. Baba, who is employed by a private security firm at the hospital, also unhesitatingly burst through a window to rescue a nurse and a patient who were trapped in a smoke-filled ward. KZN Health MEC Dr. Sibongiseni Dlomo praised Baba as being a hero for literally putting his own life on the line to save the lives of others. Baba says he is proud to have done what he did and would not hesitate to do it all over again. Meanwhile, he's also intimated that he has not lost hope of one day becoming a police officer. Some really inspirational news on this Friday. Let's get another look at what's happening in the world of sport with Graham.
Eight Premier League fixtures and counting this weekend, but most of the focus will be on Liverpool and Bournemouth tomorrow, and that's our feature match here on SABC3. Liverpool will come out with, will probably make their way back to the top of the table. Anything less than or more than a win will take them there. Then on to football, or staying with football, tomorrow evening the Soweto Derby takes centre stage. Orlando Pirates, Kaizer Chiefs locking horns at the FNB Stadium. Historically, match has been won by Kaizer Chiefs at a narrow 25-21, but we know that in recent times Pirates holding sway. On to rugby. Six Nations rugby continues this weekend. Three fixtures to look out for. Tomorrow we've got Scotland taking on the wounded beast, that is Ireland. We've got Italy facing off against Wales. Then Sunday we see two powerhouses resume their age-old rivalry, England up against France. Then on to cricket. The Proteas will have little time to rest on their laurels after their clean sweep against Pakistan in all formats of cricket, as Sri Lanka's national team make their way to Mzansi Shores. And I think the Proteas will relish the opportunity to continue sharpening their horns ahead of the 2019 edition of the World Cup. And that's where we leave our sport for now.
Thank you.
Thank you, G. Let's take another look at your traffic this morning. Starting off in Gauteng and Kemptonburg, there has been an accident on the R21 northbound after Olifantsfontein Road. That's currently obstructing the left lane. Heavy delays are expected, so please do be patient on the roads this morning. Off to the Western Cape in Observatory, on the N2 inbound, there has been an accident on Deval Drive. The right lane is currently blocked and causing heavy delays, so please do find an alternative route this morning. Off to the trains, there is an extended travel time of 20 to 30 minutes on the Northern Line. This is due to defective track circuits at Eerste River impacting the Strand and Middelsvlei inbound trains. Your next report will be at 8 o'clock this hour.
Thank you, Tabiso. Well, let's take a look at another beautiful sunrise photo that's been coming through. Alan, thank you for sending through your gorgeous skyline from Cape Town. Today, you can expect partly sunny conditions and a light morning shower, cooler temperatures than yesterday, reaching a maximum of 25 degrees Celsius. But on that note, let's take a look at the rest of the temperatures, starting off in Polokwane. A low of 15 with a high of 19 can be expected. Mbombela 17 with a high of 30. Thunder showers for Pretoria today, 18 with a high of 29. Johannesburg 17, 27. Mahikeng 18, reaching a high of 30. Klerksdorp 18, reaching a high of 31. If you're in Kimberley, 20 is your minimum, 32 your maximum. Bloemfontein 18, reaching a high of 31. We have partly cloudy conditions in Richards Bay today. A high of 32 can be expected. Pietermaritzburg, your high is 36. Durban 24 with a high of 31. Mthatha 19 reaching a high of 38. If you're in East London, 20 with a high of 33 can be expected. And sunny conditions in Cradock today with a high of 39. Port Elizabeth 19, 28. George 17 reaching a high of 26. Partly cloudy conditions in Sutherland 18 with a high of 32. Cape Town 18 reaching a high of 25. We have sunny conditions for Worcester today. A high of 36 can be expected. Springbok 19 reaching a high of 29. And Upington 22 with a high of 32 degrees Celsius. That's where we leave your weather for now on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Well, it's time to get back to some yummy treats in the kitchen using our star ingredient, Super M. And we are going to be making some delicious chocolate cupcakes that are full of chocolatey flavor and are a really, really easy recipe for making the perfect chocolate cake or cupcake.
Yeah, it's also our favorite little birthday cake recipe.
Ooh, it really
that
is.
As well. And it's very, very easy using, of course, our chocolate Super M. If you're not going to be using chocolate, you can use any of the other flavors, then you just really remove the cocoa from the actual recipe. Right. So we've got some flour, we've got some cocoa.
Nice.
It's going to go in there. All right. Some bicarb and some baking soda. Bam. It goes in there as well.
I got baking soda.
I got baking soda. Yes. A little bit of salt. All of it. There we go. And some sugar.
Some sugar.
Yes.
Mixing in all those dry
ingredients. So that's the dry ingredients.
An essential part of the baking process.
Would you mind going ahead with the wet ingredients? So first,
absolutely.
I need a cup of this in there.
Alrighty.
And you'll see it as a cup, so it's all good.
All right.
And then I'll just kind of mix this, combine this together. Lovely.
The keyword for this recipe is bake. SMS that to 33728 and we'll gladly send you the link to the recipe and you could be making this yourself.
Just like that. Are you getting there?
I don't know where the cup sign was.
What?
Was it there?
Well, normally it's 250 mil, but...
Well, that says...
Goodness.
What happened?
There, up until there.
Okay.
There says one cup, right there.
Oh my goodness.
Go. More. And
I actually just
stop.
Wanted more Super M to drink. That's what I wanted.
Exactly. All right.
But
your
baking is a science, so you can't actually deviate. You have to use what
That's
you need
That's the thing,
to use.
Exactly. You gotta use the actual ingredients. There we go. Right. Well done, look at you. We just said
it's
baking
a science
is a science.
Project.
It is a science. Okay, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna make a little well on this side.
Okay.
All right, just like that. And then let's get that eggs properly mixed.
I love how you're multitasking. You're just like
you
this.
Know.
You're just like this.
You gotta get it in there. Okay, cool. So that should be good.
The keyword for our chocolatey cupcakes today is bake. SMS it to 33728. We'll gladly send you the ingredients list and the link to the recipe, and you could be making these yourself. It is an espresso favorite birthday cake recipe.
Yep.
It's full of chocolatey flavor, but it's absolutely wonderful because you can basically turn it into any flavor cake.
Absolutely.
Just use the basic recipe. If you want to not make chocolate cake, you can take out the cocoa powder like we suggested in the beginning.
And look how nicely that comes together.
Together.
We are sorted.
Nice.
Right now.
Alrighty.
Yes. And that's it. That's your basic base. And you pop it into your little cupcake holders.
Yes.
And then you put it in the oven, you bake it at 180 degrees up until it's dry. You can pop it with a toothpick.
Let's say we're done with this.
We have our beautiful cupcakes and we have our frosting that we've made from like beautiful buttercream. There's some cocoa in there and some super M. It will be in the recipe link. You can SMS the keyword bake to 33728. I'm gonna try this, okay?
Okay.
So we've got our star nozzle on there. Come on. There we go.
Ooh, perfection.
Yes. Yes. Yes, yeah, it.
Nice.
Just like that, and we do this one. We do this
stunning.
One as well.
Look at you.
Just like that. Let's do
one
more.
Let's get the other guys in here.
Get in here. Get
and
in here.
And then we can all like maybe just decorate them.
What's going on?
Put you to work.
One more. One more.
Can I use the stars?
Stars. There's some over there. There's some honeycomb.
Honeycomb.
Are we decorating the whole situation
like that? And then you decorate it, yeah, with whatever you want.
We're pushing you right out of your own little.
Don't worry. No.
He's made the cupcakes, hasn't he?
That's it.
It's the worst. You work so hard to make a meal, and we kick you out.
Absolutely.
And
then you pop in your favorite things. You light some sparkles, and you have the most amazing birthday cupcakes.
And this one we have made especially for.
Aww. Cupcakes are so much fun to make.
Lucien Albertine, get in here, my man. Lucien celebrating his birthday today. He's turning 16.
I realize you have to eat every one of these
tonight. Happy birthday, my brother.
Happy birthday, Lucien.
We've got some sparkles.
Take a moment between the madness to just chill with Super M, made with love by Clover.
Good fun.
That was
good fun,
right?
Yeah.
Thanks for having for making these nice cupcakes
for
us. Really nice. We're going to take a quick break. On the other side of the break, we've got VJ Jono in the building. So to be setting the tone for what is meant to be the biggest weekend in Cape Town right at the beginning of the year with the Skrilla coming up. So it's a big party coming.
It is massive. We're going to get a little Friday dance on as well. We're going to work off some of these cupcakes.
You better. Yeah. Stick around.
I'm going to eat one right now.
All right.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, welcome back. You're live with Expresso. It has been a little bit crazy this morning, but it's been absolutely awesome. I think mainly because we have got an incredible lineup of performers and artists on the show today, but also down in Cape Town for a massive electronic weekend. And one of those stars, I want to say young stars, but dude, looking at your CV and the list of accolades that are growing, it looks like you've been in the game for a while. Muzi, welcome to the show, dude.
Thank you for having me.
I know it's pretty tough for you guys who live nocturnally to come and do a breakfast show.
I'm having such a hard time.
I'm looking at all of the photos that we've got of you. I just keep thinking to myself, what was he thinking? What were you thinking in that moment, man?
I hope I look good. I hope they get it right.
Intense, dude. Yeah. Buddy, I think let's start with the latest album, Afro Vision. What is the vision there? Is there a vision or are you just making good music, man?
There is a vision to show like the new sort of like wave of like African kids that are making music that they're proud of. And so taking that from Africa to the world. So this was like my vision of where that could go.
Is the world primed for it now? Yeah. I have to like fight every muscle twitch in my body to do this, but it feels like it's Hollywood is pushing for it. LA is pushing for it. The world music scene is pushing for Africa's time. Do you feel like you've got that opportunity?
Yeah, I think so. I think everyone is pushing it besides us. So like, I feel like we should like also do our parts with regards to like pushing it to the world, not having the world push Africa to Africa.
Yeah, you know exactly, what I mean?
So,
man.
Yeah, so I'm just doing my part in that whole journey.
Take ownership. I think you're being quite humble about it all, dude. Because I would imagine it's the kind of success that you only really notice in retrospect where you look back and you're like, wow, okay,
I'm
here now.
Yeah.
You've been based overseas. You've kind of picked up the interest of the likes of Diplo, Stormzy, Black Coffee. Do they tell you personally that they dig your music and dig your vibe, or do you only read about this in like press releases and things?
No, they tell me. They tell me personally, which I'm lucky enough to have that thing.
Awesome, man.
Yeah, so it's really cool. Having Chris Martin, being in studio with him, being like, oh, you're really good. I'm like, no, you're
nice. My mom has always said it, but now I believe it, man. Of course, down for the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival this weekend. Yeah. Dude, can't wait to see you in action as well, give people a little bit of a taste of what's to come. But thank you so much for joining us this morning, man. We appreciate it. I know you've got a busy weekend ahead.
Yeah, thank you for having me, man. Red Bull Music Stage is going to be really a vibe.
It's going to be hot. So if you haven't got your tickets already, I don't know if there are any left, but you want to do it. It's going down Cape Town Electronic Music Festival at the Castle of Good Hope, Cape Town. $200 to $600 will get you in, and you want to get there. It's going to be awesome.
Alrighty, so it is that time of a Friday morning. Did you tune in for every Expresso show this week? I hope so. Have you been listening? Have you been paying attention? Well, it is time to play our Expresso Rewind game, in which we'll see how we can remember, how much we can remember from this week's shows. And our contestants on the count, Leanne, Tabiso, Zoe Brown. You guys are ready. Okay, you guys
know how
it works. Should I refresh the rules?
You can.
Yeah, you can.
I have to finish the question before you make your sound as we compete for the coveted golden monkey that's sitting over there and he's waiting for his owner. Leanne, what's your sound?
Woo!
Right. Tabba.
Oh!
Zoe.
Zoe. My sound will be my name, so you know whose sound it is.
Okay, is it going to go for Zoe, or is it going to go Zah?
You have a strategy.
It will be a variation of that.
Yeah, it's going to be Zah! Okay, cool. So, you have to wait for me, okay? There's a social media question for you as well, but stick around. I'll give you that now, but play along with us.
And indeed. You and the iPad?
Here we go. Listen, what's with the iPad there?
I'm putting it away.
No.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, here we go. First and foremost, what legume do you use to make falafel? That was a clear winner, Leanne.
Chickpeas.
Yes, she got it right. 1 point to Leanne. Congratulations.
Yeah, I was paying attention.
Okay, here we go. Next question. Are you ready?
Yes.
What is Aston Wiley's new single called?
I remember it was a beautiful single.
Okay, yes.
Can you give us a clue?
Tell me so.
Clue, please.
Okay, it's not fixed, but it is.
Broken.
And?
Woo! I know, Bold and Beautiful.
What? That's no.
A Broken Beautiful.
Okay, 1 point for Leanne, 1 point for Tabiso. Broken.
Okay.
Broken and beautiful. I feel like I've given that away. Okay, cool. So 1 point. Leanne's got two. She's in the lead. Zoe can start playing anytime now. Ard Matthews will be opening for which English rock band in March?
Oh.
Oh, yes.
Fume?
Nope.
It's a four-letter thing, man.
No.
Was I even here this week?
Do you want a clue?
Clue, please.
Do you want a clue? Okay, cool. So, if you're sick, you need to find...
Help. What's going on in there?
I know the answer.
What is the cure?
The Cure Festival.
Yes.
I knew it was a four-letter word as well. 2-2.
This is the tiebreaker between Leanne and Tava. Okay. Where is the free ride mountain biking event Darkfest taking place?
Okay, I feel like Zoe hasn't had a chance to answer.
I will give it to Zoe.
It's like Stellenbosch.
It is indeed in Stellenbosch. Well done, Zoe.
How are we splitting this monkey?
You're not splitting it. Leanne is getting
the
golden
monkey.
Leanne, there's the monkey.
Thank you.
You get the golden monkey.
Do we both get like two points?
No, but I was kind and I gave Zoe an opportunity.
Oh, wow. Is that the reward for kindness?
Look, yes.
The only rule is there is no rules. Okay, that's pretty much how it goes. So here's one for you at home as well. The question is...
When last did you kiss a monkey?
Should. I kissed you this morning. Wow. I don't know how to come back from that. Okay. Oh, okay. Here's a question for you. Should Katlego still be allowed to make omelets on the show?
No!
That's what we want to know. Share your answer with us on social media. And if you're not sure what it is, well, visit our YouTube channel to watch videos from the past week and listen out for the answer.
That was unanimous.
All right, we're out.
Oh, share the monkey, guys. That's just awful, okay? So we have a golden monkey on that side. That's what I'm saying. So, Patty Munro, first of all, you're just so awesome. You're so phenomenal. You've
Thanks
earned
for
yourself.
Coming to class.
You know, it's that 2019 sass, girl. No, absolutely love it. You are a class act. So thank you so much for gracing us with your presence. You've earned a drink from Princess My Queen. What do you want?
Princess. Can I please get a chai latte?
Can I have a frappe? We'll fight over it. Just have a taste of that and see if I can't turn you around.
Okay.
Patty Munro is going to bring you another unbelievable performance, and she is just so phenomenal. I know we're gushing, but she's worth it. Then we're going to take a look at that feel-good news, put a smile on your dial. And what do you think?
That's it, baby.
Hey?
Boom. Niet slecht.
Boom.
That's lekker.
Come on.
What's your flavor? Cool down the tasty way this summer and enjoy a moment in between with McCafe.
On a mission, no time for fools, that's how you stay winning. Queen got the vision, now we living lavish in the
show. It's time for your daily dose of feel good.
So cool.
Welcome back. You are tuned in to your Feel Good Breakfast Show Express right here on SABC3. It's a Friday. It's so good to be hanging out with you, man. It really is. Hope you're feeling those weekend vibes because it has been an amazing show thus far. And to continue right now, it is that magical time of the day where we get to look at funny and amazing videos from all over the world in an attempt to make you just feel good. That's what we want to do.
We'll make you feel good and maybe also make you think, wait, what? So that is our thing for today, the first one up. Now, if you've ever been on the beach and you've wondered what makes those teeny tiny little bubbles, well, there is someone that couldn't keep their curiosity out anymore. Take a look.
Okay, so there's the little bubbles. We see that often.
It's crabs, isn't it? Some little crabs. Little things. Wait, what?
Oh, they use the shovel to get to it.
Isn't it those little things? Huh? Wait, what? Just waiting for like a gigantic shark to come up.
That does look a bit like a crab, but...
Oh! It's a massive crab! Oh,
no, man.
It's not a little...
Wow! Whoa.
Adieu!
It's like Jurassic Park or something. What?
You?
Wow. Wait, what?
Okay, stay away from the bubbles at the beach.
That is so hectic. Well, this next one, a TV zone. How many times have you found yourself watching a TV show and you were so zoned in on it that you weren't aware what was going on around you? Have a look at this button here.
I saw this, man.
Oh, it's a puppy.
I think he's watching 101 Dalmatians or something.
That's what my face often looks like. It's the weather. He's watching the weather.
Wow. Oh, my goodness.
That is so, it's
so adorable.
It's like just
zoned in, man.
Zoned in. Yeah.
That's cute. Oh, what's going to happen to the puppies? Okay. Oh,
he looks a little bit worried. You're
very concerned.
So sometimes you know you're in trouble. You're in a fight and you just got to call it. You got to know your limitations and call a time out exactly like this. Pup, take a look at this.
There's some food.
No food, you're gonna bed hungry.
Oh man.
Oh, he knows that. You know, it's a good dog.
And they played a trick on him as well. They were like, use the food there to come and like, what did you do?
Oh, wow. So that's our daily dose of feel good. This will be happy on your Friday. Listen, please send us any interesting or funny videos maybe that you have come across that makes you feel good. And we can share them with the rest of Mzansi right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Remember to use that hashtag #ExpressoShow. Cool, guys, are you ready for another performance?
I am. Absolutely love Paddy Munro. She is preparing for another performance, but let's get through those official duties one more time, get into our news headlines. Obviously on the sporting front, a massive weekend.
Yeah.
Everyone has been polarized. I think the entire country, and by the sounds of it, half of the continent has been polarized. Oh, that's where to Dobby, but you can let us know on our social media platforms. Is this going to finally be the opportunity for Chiefs to turn it around? Oh, all things are pointing towards the Buccaneers holding sway, but let's find out what's happening before I get polarized on air. Let's find out what's happening in our news headlines.
In the national news this morning, President Cyril Ramaphosa delivered his second State of the Nation address in Parliament in Cape Town last night. In his address, he announced that the general election would be on the 8th of May and that the government is to start a process of splitting the debt-laden Eskom into three parts: generation, transmission, and distribution. He also announced the reconfiguration of the intelligence service and the establishment of a state capture investigative directorate in the National Prosecution Authority. The president's sonar was met with general praise and was delivered free of any disruptions. The French oil giant Total yesterday announced that it has made a significant natural gas discovery off the Southern Cape coast, about 180 kilometers off the coast in Mossel Bay. The so-called Brilpadda find, estimated at about 1 billion barrels, could be enough to supply South Africa's refineries for almost 4 years. President Ramaphosa last night also referred to this first deep water discovery in his State of the Nation address and said it could be a game changer for the South African economy. Now moving further abroad, heads of state and government representatives are gathering in Ethiopia this week for a meeting of the African Union. The meeting's main focus will be on the refugee crisis. They will discuss issues such as rising challenge of refugees and internally displaced persons following conflicts in some parts of Africa. South Sudan, the Central African Republic, Nigeria, the DRC and Somalia alone generated at least 2 million newly displaced persons in the first half of 2018. The diplomatic row between France and Italy yesterday deepened, with France complaining of unfounded attacks and outlandish claims by Italian leaders. France recalled its ambassador to Italy for talks, saying the situation was unprecedented since the end of World War II. It comes after Italian Deputy Prime Minister Luigi Di Maio met French Yellow Vest protesters near Paris on Tuesday. France warned him not to interfere with the country's politics. The two governments have of late clashed over a range of issues, including immigration. And finally, thinking on your feet, remaining calm under pressure, and applying months of training and practice. This is what truck technician Miles Swanepoel had to do to beat 64 other technicians from 32 participating countries across the world in the recent World Technical Competition in Japan. Swanepoel ended in fourth place overall in the individual Grand Prix commercial vehicle division of the competition. The top three spots went to technicians from Japan, Indonesia, and Australia, respectively. But we want to say a big well done to Miles. South Africans are indeed making the world take notice on all fronts. Well, time for a final look at what's happening in the world of sport. Here is Graham Richards.
Well, football obviously dominating this weekend. A plethora of fixtures in the Premier League, but everyone is going to be seeing what happens tomorrow at 5 o'clock right here on SABC3, that encounter between Liverpool and a high-flying Bournemouth. If Liverpool comes out with anything more than a loss, they will be back at the top of the Premier League title race. Then staying with the beautiful game, tomorrow evening, the Soweto Derby takes centre stage. Orlando Pirates locking horns once again with Kaizer Chiefs. The winner takes all battle has been ongoing since its inception back in 1970. And while historically, I think the match has been won by Kaizer Chiefs at a narrow 25-21 victories, Pirates have certainly held sway in recent times. Then a little further afield in Rugby Six Nations. Rugby continues this weekend with three fixtures to look out for. Tomorrow we've got Scotland taking on Ireland, Italy up against Wales, and on Sunday two rugby powerhouses resume their rivalry, England taking on France. Now currently England and Scotland are tied for top spot in their standings at 5 points apiece, with Wales not far behind on four. Then finally on to cricket. Proteas, they're going to be back in action again. They don't have much time to rest on their laurels after their clean sweep against Pakistan, as Sri Lanka's national cricket team makes its way to Mzansi Shores. That kicks off on Wednesday. South Africa historically faring better in their games with Sri Lanka than Pakistan, but all focus now will be on the ICC World Cup coming up in May and continuing to hone those skills and build that momentum. So going to be a very interesting lineup. That's where we leave our sport for this Friday morning.
Thank you, G. Let's take a final look at your roads this morning. We head off to Gauteng once more in Bedford View, where there has been an accident on the M12 westbound before the R24 turnoff, causing congestion from Jet Park with delays up to 20 minutes. Please be patient this morning. Still in Gauteng and Kelvin on Marlborough Drive, there is protest action before the Gautrain station, and heavy delays can be expected between the M1 and N3. Please find an alternative route this morning. Off to the trains, there is an extended travel time of 15 to 20 minutes on the Cape Flats line. This is due to sets being out of service as well as speed restrictions. That's where we leave your traffic for the morning. Zoe standing by with the weather.
Thank you, Tabiso. Well, here is a quick roundup of the beautiful sunrise photos that's been coming through. Asa, thank you for your beautiful sunrise from Houdini, as well as Buddha for your amazing sunrise from Daveyton. Then Alan, your spectacular blue skyline from Cape Town. We really appreciate each and every picture that's been coming through. If you have a sunrise photo you'd love to share with us, feel free to do so on the Expresso Facebook page. But here is a quick and final look at your temperatures. Polokwane 15 with a high of 29 for today. Mbombela 17, reaching a high of 30. Pretoria 18, 29. Johannesburg 17, 27. Partly cloudy conditions in Mahikeng 18 with a high of 30. Klerksdorp 18 with a high of 31. Kimberley 20, 32. Bloemfontein 18, 31. We also have partly cloudy conditions in Richards Bay 23 with a high of 32. Pietermaritzburg 18, 36. Durban 24 with a high of 31, Mthatha 19 reaching a high of 38, East London 20 reaching a high of 33, Craddock 17, 39. If you're in Port Elizabeth, 19 is your minimum, 28 your maximum. Partly cloudy conditions in George, a low of 17, a high of 26. If you're in Sutherland, 18 with a high of 32 can be expected. Cape Town 18, 25, Worcester 17 reaching a high of 36. If you're in Springbok, 19 with a high of 29 can be expected. And Upington, a low of 29 with a high of 32 degrees Celsius. And that's where we leave your weather on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
I hope you're ready. I really hope you're ready. Something fresh and new, not just for us, but for Patty Munro as well, AKA Mama Malachi, AKA Young Messi, AKA Scary Poppins. And she's brought her crew with her, VJ Jono in the house. It's time to fill your cup.
All right. I got the right apparatus, and this moment in time you remember for the rest of your life. Cause I'ma make you mine. I'ma fill your cup, I'ma pour it up till you had enough. But this moment never come. I'ma fill your cup, I'ma pour it up till you had enough. But this moment never come. Will this moment ever come? 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 Will this moment ever come?
Women on a mission, attention. No time for fools, that's how you stay winning. Queen got the vision, L. Now we living lavish in a lush kingdom. You got the juice, I got the sauce. Marinate all day long. We don't really need to go out if you don't want. No need for their opinion.
I'ma fill your cup,
I'ma fill your cup,
I'ma pour it up,
I'ma pour it up
till you had enough,
till you had enough.
I'ma fill your cup,
I'ma fill your cup,
I'ma pour it up,
I'ma pour it up
till you had enough,
till you had enough. Coachella, give you all the things you never had. You already know a spec. You already know I'm mad. But you keep coming back. Cause I'm
a failure cup.
I'm a failure cup.
I'm a pour it.
Come on.
Up.
I'm a pour it up.
Till you had enough.
Till you had enough.
I'm a failure cup.
I'm a failure cup.
I'm a pour it up.
I'm a pour it up.
Till you had enough.
Till you had enough.
Will this moment ever come?
My brother.
Wow.
You know, I mean, the whole studio is walking around with stank face. Just like, that is awesome.
Thank you.
You are a superstar. You. Oh, you can see her live, and you really do want
guys,
to see her live.
Back.
Cape Town Electronic Music Festival going down at the Castle of Good Hope. It is going to be phenomenal. You can see the likes of VJ Jono in the mixer as well. An incredible lineup. In fact, we've got DJ Muzi here as well. He's going to perform for you after the break. We're going to get our Friday dance on. You've got Princess dancing.
Hi,
and you guys doing a little choreography.
No. I sent her the message
We love what you have done today. Thank you so much.
Thanks
for bringing some
me.
New music. It's just so awesome. We'll see you after the break.
You're welcome.
I'm guessing that was the radio.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. SABC3 has got some really great films this weekend if you're looking to kick back and just relax, starting off with Buried Secrets. Now, this film is about a cop-turned-writer who creates suspicion when she publishes her first novel, a story that appears to contain details of a real murder. Let's take a look.
Today, a bombshell hit local bookshelves. Ex-police detective Sarah Winter's first novel, Justice in Limbo, is creating quite the controversy.
It's fiction.
But is it true that you were forced to resign from the police force 12 months ago following allegations of corruption?
Brenda? Sir, could you please get to the back of the line?
It's going to hurt.
This is going to get nasty.
I write a book, and all of a sudden I'm public enemy number one.
Get that book off the shelf. Exercise your freedom!
Freedom of speech is far more important.
Buried Secrets, Friday at 9:30 on 3. The stage is yours.
Ooh la 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 la, it looks like a thriller.
It looks like a thriller, and of course, if that's not enough for you, on Saturday, SABC3, they have a family drama. It's called Rachel Getting Married, starring Anne Hathaway and Rosemary DeWitt. Now, the film follows a young woman who has been in and out of rehab for the past 10 years, who returns home for the weekend for her sister's wedding. Take a look.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Kim, good luck to you.
God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change.
Why is Emma the maid of honor? Why am I not the maid of honor? Because I wasn't entirely sure when you were coming or if you'd even make it.
You know, I never had anorexia. And you certainly didn't watch over me while I was sleeping.
No, it's like you're not happy unless I'm in some kind of a desperate situation. You have no idea what to do with me unless I'm in crisis.
Mom? Why would you leave a drug addict to watch your son?
She lied in rehab.
What do you mean she lied?
I mean, she lied, Rachel, to the people who were working with her, who were trying to help her.
Rachel Getting Married, Saturday at 7 on 3.
Wow, gripping stuff on the weekend. Well, Sunday night's also covered with SABC3 and the Bollywood crime thriller Rustam, which follows a naval officer who returns home to find out about his wife's affair and soon after murders her lover. But that's not where the story ends. As the case unfolds, hidden intentions start to reveal themselves.
A dedicated naval officer, a scheming friend, and an unfaithful wife form the three points of a deadly triangle in Rustam, a crime thriller and courtroom drama starring Akshay Kumar, Ileana D'Cruz, and Arjun Bajwa. This award-winning movie shows Indian cinema at its peak. Rustam on SABC3. The stage is yours.
Well, you certainly won't be bored.
Exactly. I love Bollywood. I thought it was really serious, but I think there might just be an opportunity to get some dancing in there.
There's a lot of music involved, so of course you will be entertained this entire weekend thanks to SABC3 and their fantastic movie lineup.
Well, SABC3 certainly has you covered. And this week on Top Billing, we bring you the exclusive action from the 2019 Sun Met with Usain Bolt. And Jonathan Boyton Lee, he catches up with entrepreneur Amanda Dambuza. Catch all of this and more this Sunday at 5:30 p.m. on SABC3 with a repeat on Tuesday at 3:30 p.m.
Join the party on hashtag Top Billing this Sunday evening at 5:30 as Greg Hammond and Chanel Sardina say I do at the Polo.
My school and her school were sort of sister brother school years ago. We kept in touch. I came out to Cape Town to study, moved back up, and we reconnected, and the rest was history.
Expresso's Tobiso Macobella shows off his new apartment, talks style and life on Breakfast TV.
How has life been post-competition?
Life after the competition has been incredible. I wake up really early every morning, but I wake up to live my dream.
With a theme of Africa's natural metals, the A-list step out in copper, silver, and gold for a day at the races.
Join us this week as we bring you the glitz, the glamour, and the stunning stallions at Africa's richest racing day, the Sun Met 2019.
Ryle discovers flower power in the healing plants of the Adelaide Botanical Gardens.
How does this structure actually protect the plants inside?
There's thousands of foggers attached to the roof, and once the weather becomes warm, those foggers come on. They don't only add to the humidity, but they actually act as a giant evaporative cooler.
International Business Woman of the Year, wife and mother, Amanda Dambuza, somehow finds time to design her dream home.
Jonathan, this is where the magic happens.
Not in the bedroom, but the magic happens here, hey?
This is another kind of magic.
And singer-songwriter James Morrison tours SA with his first album in 3 years.
People of South Africa, I'm James Morrison. I'm here in your beautiful country. Catch me on Top Billing.
That's this Sunday at 5:30 p.m. where the stage is yours on SABC3.
You give me something that makes me scared, all right.
Oh, so beautiful.
And feast your eyes, Mzanzi. Look at that, a cheesy pull-apart bread, something that you have to have on the menu when you are going to be braaiing this weekend, because it is a Braai Friday, and this is what we are whipping up. It's full of deliciousness, it's full of cheese, it's full of flavour. There's brie, onion, marmalade, figs, whatever is in there. Chef Tash will run us through. Good yes. morning, give us a high five.
Good
it's
morning.
A Friday. Welcome to your Beautiful Breakfast Show. Lovely to have you, Tash.
Thank you.
This is amazing.
It is amazing. It wow. smells amazing. It looks amazing.
Look, just the smell of it alone is fantastic. I can sit here the whole morning and just smell it, and then we'll devour it.
You can have just one piece. It's a pull-up bread.
Yes.
A pull-apart bread.
Yes.
So you can just pull up one piece.
So what you're going to do, you're going to pull apart one, then we're going to do a pull-up.
Oh, yes.
Just because. You know, okay, cool. Let's make it. First of all, the type of bread that you use obviously is very important.
Yes, yes. This is a sourdough loaf.
Okay.
So the reason why we use a sourdough loaf is that it's hard and it's dense.
Okay.
So it's going to hold the cheese very nicely.
Right.
And we are using this beautiful blue cheese. Cheese sauce. We are using onion marmalade, and it's got mustard seeds in it,
yes.
so it goes very nicely with the onion. And then we're using figs.
Right.
These are fig preserves, as you can see. They're not very fresh, so they are nice and sweet.
Yes.
And we are going to have brie as well.
Oh man! And the fig combination with the sweetness and the brie cheese is always
yes.
a winning combination. But look at this. So you kind of cut them in these squares.
Diagonally, yes.
yes.
So what you do, you want to achieve the pull-up effect.
Yes.
You achieve with the little squares.
So you don't cut it all the way through, be careful
with that. Not all the way through, because you are going to sauce it up, and if you cut it all the way through, it's going to fall apart.
Okay.
So we are bending it backwards because we want to create those nice spaces.
Right.
And then we are going to stuff it with some cheese, this brie cheese.
Let's get in there. The keyword is bread. If you want to get your hand
yes.
on the recipe, the keyword is bread. SMS that to 33728. Definitely, like I mentioned, something that needs to be on your braai menu this weekend.
Yes.
Because it's amazing. Nothing like pull-apart bread. It's festive. I could say it's festive. It's a festive atmosphere at home with your friends and your family. Everyone just grabs a piece. It's amazing.
It is quite festive. People are very scared of using blue cheese because of the pungent taste. But then when you pair it with the figs and the onion marmalade, it's got that nice sweetness, and it becomes very nice and gooey and creamy and everything.
Yes, it kind of melts into that bit. So you cut these kind of slivers of it.
Yes. Please help me.
Okay, okay.
And then you're going to start on this side, I'll start on this side.
I'll try and not eat it. So you just go straight down?
Yes, straight down.
Ah, look at that. So it slots in very nicely.
Very nice and quick.
I'll grab this part for you.
Okay, thank you.
Let's get another one in there. So you fill it in everyone. Yeah.
You can, fill it in everyone.
I'll try it.
Then we are going to drizzle the blue cheese on top. Just to add to the cheesiness.
Yes.
And we are going, please help me with the figs as well.
Okay, so figs we can also load in there.
Yes.
I almost feel like I should use my hands for this one.
But I there always we go. Use my hands.
Yeah, I think
it's
that's a better idea. Hands are clean, so there we go. So get that in there because you can really get stuck in there with.
Oh, yes.
Oh, this is stunning. Like I've mentioned, the keyword, if you want to get your hands on this recipe, is bread. SMS that to 33728. That's bread.
Okay.
To 33728.
What I prefer to do as well, before we drizzle it with the blue cheese sauce,
okay.
Just foil it up so that if anything falls on, you save it. So when you're going to put it on the grill, it falls on the foil.
Right. Well, there we go. Okay, hang on.
Okay.
Just like that. Our figs
That's
are
small.
In there.
and then
and now you get, just get that onion marmalade in there. So just to fast forward a little bit whilst you are busy with this, I'll kind of lift it for you.
Yes, please.
So once you've done with it, how do you get it to that?
Okay, we are going to wrap it with a foil. I see that I've cut a little bit too smaller foil. And then you wrap it up, you put it on the grill, you leave it there and until the cheese has melted.
Okay.
And it's going to create a beautiful crust because it is a crusty bread.
Yes.
Sourdough is a crusty bread.
That's
so we are looking for that pull apart effect.
Okay, awesome. And then just a drizzle of that cheese sauce and you're good to go. That keyword is bread. SMS that to 33728 to get your hands on the recipe. Take your braai to another level this weekend and then that goes in. That will melt down into the bread as well, that blue cheese.
This
what
is
a combination
decadence.
Of flavors. Okay, so I'm going to pull out one of these. I know it looks nice, but I need to try.
Go in there, go in there.
Come on.
Oh, goodness me. I'm pulling out more than I'm... Oh, look at that.
Oh.
Look at that. Okay,
the gooiness.
Hang on.
Eat it!
Oh, wow.
Eat it!
In
the face. Put it in
the jealousy that's going around now is ridiculous. This is so good. You get the sweetness, the cheese. I'm not going to talk. I'm not.
How's it fit?
Amazing. Yes. Absolutely amazing. You finish that, raise the keyword, SMS that to 33728 and have a lekker braai.
It's tough, man.
It's never easy. Listen, we need a break on that note. At the end of the break, on the other side, we're doing En Vogue and En Time, our latest in your fashion news.
And then we're going to get super judgy, okay? We're going to play a game of fab or fail. Who's winning, who's losing in the fashion game? Of course, Nick joins us for that. And we'll digest this in the meantime. We'll see you after the break.
I'm going to eat.
Come on, dude. Come on, man.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Now, you know when you hear that tune what exactly it means. This is Expresso, your feel-good breakfast show. And what's the best way to wrap up another week right here on your feel-good breakfast show? How about with a fashion roundup of only the need to know in news trending this week? Cue Fashion Fix, everybody, En Vogue and En Time, and here to serve us with a platter of news, ensuring we move into the weekend in style, is our fashion editor, Nick Strellis.
A platter. A platter. A gluten-free platter.
Ooh, a gluten-free.
I'm gluten-free.
You are gluten-free.
And I'm allergic.
Indeed.
It's not an intolerance.
Wow.
I just want to start with that.
A lot of information.
It's not fashion news, but I want to talk about it.
But let's talk fashion.
I guess we can.
International fashion.
I guess we will. Okay.
What's happening?
Guys, it's New York Fashion Week right now for the autumn-winter 19 season. Check my roundup next week, everyone. But first, I want to talk about a first in New York. Changing the game is New York with designer Pierre Davis.
Yes.
Now, designer Pierre Davis has just become the first transgender fashion designer to showcase at New York Fashion Week since 1943.
Okay.
Since its inception, we're doing big things. It's her brand called No Sesso. In Italian, actually translates to no sex. The brand itself is completely agender. The inspiration behind the collection, I think, is really pivotal to sort of run through. When asked about the inspiration behind the collection, Pierre Davis said, quote, "I create clothes for masculine people who want to appear more feminine, feminine people who want to appear more masculine, and everything in between."
Okay.
So, I mean, I think, again, we talk about breaking boundaries and barriers in the fashion game. This is a first. I mean, can you believe this is the first time it's ever happened?
Wow.
Since 1943.
Sure.
I mean, it's big.
Groundbreaking stuff.
It's groundbreaking. People like Erykah Badu have been pioneering the brand since 2017. She was spotted wearing one of his deconstructed shirt dresses while performing at a Soul Festival.
Wow.
So the celebrity endorsements are coming in, but I think it's just really important to note that this really pivotal moment in the fashion game.
Yeah,
it's good to know.
You need to call Tyrone.
Yeah, queen.
Call
him. Do you have his number?
No, I don't have Tyrone's number.
Perfect.
Can someone get Tyrone's number?
Can someone get me Tyrone's number, please?
What else is making
Nick single?
Yeah, okay. You would want to speak to Tyrone.
Oh, girl. Oh, okay. Okay, let's talk Jennifer Lawrence, America's sweetheart.
Who's engaged?
Well, she's engaged. Oh, this is not, okay, cool.
That is Jennifer Lawrence.
That's Jennifer Lawrence.
Yes, but that's, I'm not there yet. So I'm still talking about Jennifer Lawrence. So she just got engaged to Cook Maroney.
Yes.
Something tells me he's not gonna need to cook in anything for long now because she's rich, that's what I'm saying. So did you see what I did? Cook is his name. He doesn't need to cook because she's got so much money. Everyone will cook for him.
But maybe he's got his own money.
You have to explain Zoe Brown.
That's when the joke isn't good.
But he is a director at an art gallery. That was very rude, but I appreciate your honesty. Director at an art gallery. He represents Lena Dunham's dad.
What?
Isn't that funny? They have a lot of money, the Dunhams, but that's, again, another story.
Girl, why do you keep touching on the money?
Because I love money. I love money. Okay, let's talk about the bridesmaids. Battle of the bridesmaids, because she has two besties, Emma Stone and Amy Schumer, so we don't know who is going to be the maid of honor or one of the bridesmaids to be, which is important.
They'll probably both be bridesmaids.
Probably, yeah. Yes. But I want to talk about top tips for brides. So Glamour just released sort of their top tips, a very sort of capsule of what do's that brides should all be aware of. So number one is the top of the dress is most important. Now, when you think about what gets photographed the most at weddings, it really...
Boom, 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 boom.
Yes, 100%. Right? So people don't really think about that, so you need to make sure the bodice, the top of the dress, is milling in, because that's what's really going to be on camera. Trying on dresses. This is very, very important, obviously. You don't want to inundate yourself with options, but you also want to make sure you're trying on enough, because things on a hanger can sometimes look amazing or equally terrible, but you don't know until you've actually put it on your body.
Yeah.
So make sure you're trying on 5 to 10 dresses, maybe over a 3-day period.
Okay.
Right? Who you bring with is very important. Reality shows have us make believe that we should bring 10, 15 people, our grandmother, the guy who made us coffee last week, our dog walker, to try on dresses and get their opinion.
You need to bring the most honest person
along. Zoe Brown.
Because I don't want everyone to say, ooh, that looks nice, that looks nice. Be honest.
But even if they don't like it, they're projecting onto you, you lose sight of your vision, what you want, it becomes what everyone else wants. So maybe go with one impartial bestie. That could be your mother, someone who gives you objective advice.
Yeah.
Wedding dress sizes, this is very important. Don't be scared when you get to a wedding dress to try it on. Dresses generally come up 2 to 3 sizes larger than you really are, your actual size. So don't be devastated when you go in there and you need to go up 2 to 3 sizes. So that's just a quick tidbit. You don't want to go there and try on and want to kill yourself.
No, we don't want that. It's supposed to be your happiest day.
It's a happy day. No suicide. Let's not talk about it. I don't want to go there. And then sales are final. This is an all-important facet of trying on wedding dresses. Most wedding dresses and accessories are final sales. So do your research before. Make sure their policy is according to what you actually want.
Yeah.
Because it's important. You want your dress to speak volumes.
I feel like I might be picking out wedding dresses at the end of this year.
Can I be your impartial bestie that can
put it out there?
I want to be your maid of honor. Can I give you away?
Please.
Maybe.
Can we join you for the shopping
absolutely,
expedition?
Absolutely. Well, it's curated news that you can use. That's Fashion Fix only on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Head to Expresso's Facebook page for more on this.
Well, can you imagine a world where the worlds and the paths of all our beloved characters, such as Cinderella, Rapunzel, Prince Charming, and, the giant killer Jack, became so intertwined that it would not become a child story anymore?
So many adult themes in there to have fun with. All that fantastical world actually comes to a reality, and it's happening in a groundbreaking and looks like hilarious new production at the iconic theatre at the Bay. It's time to go into the woods.
When venturing into the woods, it can be considered foreboding, mysterious, sometimes just a little bit creepy, but it's also the perfect place to see some of your favorite fairy tale characters collide in a battle of desire and destiny. And that is exactly what you can expect at Theatre on the Bay in their brand new production, Into the Woods.
Most people may know this adult musical, which features music and lyrics written by legendary composer Stephen Sondheim from the 2014 film adaptation. But the story itself is relatively young in comparison to the source materials that inspired it.
Stephen Sondheim has given us a totally new look at a bunch of very well-known and very well-loved fairy tale characters, but he spins them on their head and gives us a very modern universe in which they're operating. We meet Rapunzel, Cinderella, Jack and the Beanstalk, Red Riding Hood, a witch, and each of them thinks that they want something desperately, and they get it. A lot of musicals require one or two stars and then an ensemble cast that sort of fills in the gaps with a chorus. In this production, it's absolutely imperative that all 15 cast members are stars in their own right, because each of them carries a very important part of the narrative.
The parts of these well-known and usually sympathetic characters all intersect as they go into the deep, dark woods on separate quests, with sometimes amusing and often unexpected results.
Hello, cast of Into the Woods. Listen, I can't wait to see this production, but talk to me about these iconic historic characters that you are playing in this almost like a modern setup. Does it change the way in which you view these characters yourself?
They're all based on the real characters. They're rooted in the real thing. But Stephen Sondheim takes it even further and extrapolates the main tale, and you see beyond the happy ending.
Even though this is all fairy tales, it's grounded in reality and it's not aimed at kids. This is something that everyone connects to. There's so many different themes that I don't think there's a single person in the audience who won't resonate with that.
There are elements which are really surprising. Your reaction to the story then is quite interesting because it's playing on things that you know and love, and I think that's a really lovely part of the story.
Now, of course, this is a musical and the music plays a very big part of this production. And from what I understand, the lyrics are very clever and witty. How does that help you portray your specific character?
And that's what makes it so exciting as a performer, because every single time you either are performing it or you're listening backstage to somebody else, you're like, oh, I haven't heard that before. And it's
that's what she's saying.
Yeah, yeah, I'm like, oh my gosh, she's so clever. Yeah, which is so exciting. It's like so colorful and yeah, complex. It's incredible.
The scope and the range of the complexity of his compositions are just so engaging to the ear to listen to, just because there's so much in the music, you know, so I really enjoy it.
When approaching the design for Into the Woods, we were aware that the show works in two very clear halves. The first half is a joyous musical mashup of traditional fairy tales. It's gloriously witty, it's laugh out loud funny, and incredibly entertaining. And for all of those reasons, we've created a very lush, typical fairy tale forest that you would expect to find in the illustrations of any classic compilation of fairy tales. The second half is much deeper, it's much more poignant and thought-provoking, and for that we have stripped away the forest and created a more bare and deconstructed look.
What an incredible production, so well put together, Into the Woods at Theatre on the Bay. Your favourite fairy tale characters like you've never seen them before. Get down to the Theatre on the Bay and experience a night out of true magic. You will not be sorry.
Oh, wow, it is Fashion Fix Friday. We're living our best lives right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Now, nothing says feel good more than standout style, which is being served right now, courtesy of Fab or Fail. So we've got our squad in the studio. They're on the couch, and we've got our trusty paddles. You know how the game works. We're going to pick one or a few red carpet moments, and then based on these paddles, we're going to decide, is it fab? Another way. Is it fail? Our fashion editor next to us, everybody. And of course, Zoe Brown, a part of our style squad.
No claps
now.
For either of us.
We are going to be taking a look at Grammy Awards this Sunday night. And we're doing a bit of a throwback to some of the more memorable moments from past editions. So, style squad, are you ready?
Yes,
we are. Okay,
yes.
Wonderful. We're going to start off with someone who always makes a statement on the red carpet.
Yes.
And that is none other than the original bad girl, Rihanna, in 2015.
Oh, my God. Face crack.
Yes.
What?
Now I would go
what?
Here. Back then, I think we said that.
I would still say that. She looks like a Barbie.
And how fresh-faced as well. I mean, Rivi does no wrong in my books.
Skin is winning.
Yeah, flawless.
Flawless. All right, let's move on to the queen of hip-hop, Lil' Kim, 2002.
Dude, can you vote not against Lil' Kim?
What do you like about that outfit?
It's just Lil' Kim. Anything other than outrageous would be underwhelming for me. And why does she have a motorcycle hat with her?
That's why I'm giving her this.
Yeah, that's why we're doing this.
She be riding to the club and to...
Don't be asking questions.
No, she's
about
on her red carpet at the Grammys.
All right. It's British songstress and Grammy Award winner Adele at the 2013 Awards.
Girl, I like it. I did not sleep well last night.
Because you
and
were
now
too
I know why. No, because Adele
skin.
Came in and she took those curtains, girl, and
yeah,
she knit it together.
But she's pulling it off. Kim didn't pull it off.
But how
but
old
she's
is Adele? So
off.
She's supposed to be like 21 here. She looks about what?
She does look mature, but it's still a cute dress.
Do you know what
okay.
she did? She basically stole her granny's curtains and made a dress.
Okay, that was my joke.
Adele,
first.
I like
I
it.
Said that. Yep.
Now, it is the undisputed princess of pop, Miss Britney Spears, in 2000. Yes!
Yeah, queen!
Yes?
It's a unanimous yes.
Yo, you know I'm a big Britney fan.
I love this look. She looks
girl,
so innocent
I'm
there.
I'm not a girl, don't tell me what's about here.
Okay, making a serious splash in 2014 installment. It's singer-producer extraordinaire, Pharrell.
Okay.
Wow.
Do you remember this hat?
I remember this hat.
Read they this were... tweet though. Someone got Pharrell takes off his hat and there's a tiny other guy from the Neptunes under it.
Wow, that was a statement hat though.
It was a statement hat.
But is that Grammy's attire though? It just looks like he's walking down the street.
That's kind of his shtick though, isn't it? Like yeah. He's not someone to sort of buy
up
into.
A little for the Grammys.
Yeah. Maybe. All right. And then finally, we could not have a red carpet without the queen herself, Beyonce, in 2002.
I can't believe I'm voting no for Beyonce.
No, voting no for Beyonce. This
it's
nice. Wasn't this when mom was still
I was going to say, I don't want to blame anyone but Tina Knowles.
Tina Knowles.
She looks like Aladdin's girl.
The mistress, not Jasmine. Because Aladdin was seeing someone else, Jasmine's cousin named
Do not break up
Jasmona.
A happy home. Do not say that about Aladdin, okay? Brittany, thank you.
Okay.
Anyways, that's, of course, some of the most memorable red carpet moments from the Grammy Awards. That's Fashion Fix, always on time and on Vogue. You can head to our Facebook page for more of these amazing throwbacks, so you can go and check that out. And definitely we'll be catching up with the Grammys.
Yes, Grammys.
Next
Why don't you
week.
Sing for us again?
We're going to take a quick ad break. We'll see you right back after.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Expresso right here on SABC3. Now, we have got an amazing guest in studio. It is a fantastic Friday, but what would a Friday be without a young game that we need to get involved in? And one that we really love playing is charades. You know how the game goes, all right? So here we've got a bowl in front of us, and there are different things in the bowl that we need to be able to read out and then kind of act to our partner who needs to guess who or what we are. All right,
yes.
So our game is going to be played with Miss Mad Patty Monroe and Moody. And it's a game of charades. Are you guys ready? Did you know about this?
No.
Okay, oh, well, we love to surprise you guys.
We're playing. All right.
So the two of you will be on a team. Myself and Leanne will be on a team.
So
and
the
I think.
Team and the...
The what team?
The winning team and the...
the losing team, clearly.
I didn't say that.
All right, so you're going to pick something out of here, and then you're going to read it, make sure that your partner doesn't see. You've got to act it out, and then you've got a couple of seconds to guess what it is, all right? Because you are the guest, we'll let you go first. The winning team. Okay, go for it.
Okay. Are you ready?
Okay. He needs to act it out to you.
So I must know. So I go to as I see.
Show the camera what it is.
I'm acting it out. I'm acting it out.
Dentist smile, grills. What? Cheese. Cheese. More, more. More what? Take it back.
The grill.
Grill.
You can't talk.
Cheese. Oh. What? Smile. Colgate smile. Dentures. What? What do you want?
Ah, no.
Why did he?
Braces.
Oh. You should have done like this. You should have done this.
Show it to camera.
Okay, are you ready?
I'm ready.
It's a warm-up, there's a warm-up, guys.
Cool. All right.
Here we go.
Sad blow? Oh, sad crown. Ooh, pregnant. Happy clown. This is rough. Okay,
we've got one.
Yeah, you go.
No pressure. Muzi. There we go.
On your marks, get it.
Go,
go.
Hockey.
You can stand, you can stand.
Football. World Cup.
Yes.
Is it World Cup?
What?
PlayStation.
Yes.
FIFA.
Yes. So what? What did they?
They got a brandy.
What?
No.
That's
time.
Soccer player, man.
Oh.
Supposed to see this? Yes, I am.
Yes,
okay.
You're supposed to see it.
You guys know these things.
Oh,
know
my shillings. Goodness.
Okay, I play all day shillings.
Three, two, one, go for it.
Okay, cool.
Climbing, wall, rock climbing, wall, walking, pudding, ladder.
Yes, oh my God.
Oh,
there we go.
Easy ones.
There we go.
And that is the end of the game, ladies and gentlemen, from the new winning team.
Thank you, Ms.
Patty Monroe.
That was a nice warm-up, eh? Let's
play the game. Okay, wonderful. We're going to start right after this. Now we're ready to play the real game.
Fun and games, man. Fun and games on your Feel Good Breakfast show this morning. It's still a Friday. It's still a Bri Friday. We still have Tash with us. And to accompany our beautiful cheesy pull-apart bread we made a little bit earlier on, we have these jalapenos wrapped in bacon on the Bri as a snack. To go with your bread. I don't think anything can get any better this morning than this, Tia.
Nothing can get better. And the beautiful thing about these jalapenos, they've got that nice sweetness. Because they're baked, they're not that chili as your normal chilies.
But I mean, kid, the bacon wrapped around it, that flavor as well, we're all infused, is going to be amazing. So let's put it together. How does it work? So we've got our jalapenos.
We've got jalapenos, spring onion, we've got cheese, we've got the bacon, and we've got a beautiful barbecue sauce.
Okay.
So we are going to start with the stuffing.
Right.
We are going to use the spring onion.
Spring onion, okay.
Yes. So when you buy your jalapenos, choose the bigger ones so that you can stuff them nicely.
Oh, look at that, and a piece of cheese.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, you're really going for it, eh? Oh.
And if you look at the bacon, try and get...
What cheese are you using? What is this?
Mozzarella.
Mozzarella cheese,
yes.
Okay.
So we are going to close up this lid.
Right.
And then we are going to wrap it around so it's a nice parcel.
Oh, my goodness.
And then before you put it on the grill, put a skewer in there. Always remember to wedge your skewers so that they don't burn.
So you can wedge it like this, or you can wedge it sideways, whatever you want. Okay, cool.
And then we are going to put it on the grill.
Okay, wait, I'm gonna try making one as well while you do that. The keyword is snack. SMS that to 33728, that's snack to 33728. And then, of course, that delicious barbecue basting.
Oh, yes.
It's gonna go on there as well.
Yes. How easy is that?
Let's see if we're gonna get this guy in there. Yes, there we go. Okay, so a piece of bacon, close up the end.
Close up, and then
we start
wrap around.
Wrapping around, just like that. Okay, I'm getting it, I'm getting it. There we go. Oh, beautiful.
Awesome.
Beautiful. And then I'm gonna stick it through like that. You hold it, and
oh,
we have a beautiful, tuck that piece in. That's as easy as that, that goes onto the Bri.
And then
you baste it.
We are going to baste it.
Oh my goodness, that looks amazing. The keyword is treat. SMS that to 33728. You Bri it up until the bacon is nice and done. It's crispy, whatever. The barbecue flavor with the mozzarella and the spring onion in there. It's gonna be a burst of flavors. The keyword is snack. SMS that to 33728. That's snack to 33728. But as usual, you can catch all of these recipes on our website, expressoshow.com. Can I try one?
Yes, please.
Yeah? Yeah, there's a lot there. That's a lot. Okay, I'll take off one.
Pull one out.
All right, hang on.
Ooh.
Mmm. There it is.
It smells amazing.
How's that for breakfast?
How is that for breakfast?
Got a spice, a bite to it, nice and chilly. I love it. Snack to 33728, put it there. Bam. And you can make this. Make this. No, you can make this. You have to make this.
You have to make this.
Have to make it. Snack 23378.
It's a beautiful canapé.
Mm.
How is that?
Oh, lest we forget, it's a Friday. It's a Fri-yay. It's going to be a big weekend in Cape Town, preparing for the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival happening at the Castle of Good Hope. Some superstar performers have graced our presence this morning, like the two of these. Jonah, thank you so much for adding your voice, figuratively speaking, to the mix. Dude, I'm sorry we traumatized you with a game of charades, man, but we're going to let you do what you do at an unbelievable level right now, ladies and gentlemen, to round us off with one final massive performance. It's Muzi.
vision, our vision, our vision. New single next week. Let's go. Pause.
Daylight! Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds, it's a daylight. Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds, it's a daylight. Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds, it's a daylight. I know. Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds is a delight. Conk, conk. Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds is a delight. Conk, conk. Lead me on to the daylight. I know it's warm in the daylight. Sun through the clouds is a delight.
That's awesome, dude. I understand what they mean about an unmistakable sound, your vibe. It's been an absolute pleasure hosting you, man.
Thank you for having me, man.
So down to earth and just cool, man. Thank you. Thank you for being that on our show today.
I've only seen you on TV, bro. This is weird.
It's so weird, man. I've just seen you at your worst doing your charades, man. So I feel like we've bonded. No, it's been awesome. Go and see this man perform live at the Cape Town Electronic Music Festival. Tickets are very reasonable. Go and check it out. It's going to be one of the parties of the year, and you will hear bangers like that. The Friday Dance after the break. Nicely done, dude.
Thank you, man. Only you can make my day.
I'm trying to get your nails like a fib. I'm trying to change this test into a bib. Pop a bottle of the Hollywood dip. She said she was a man of freedom. And I'ma get it any type of way. If it's real, then you say it to my face. I'm proud to say my name, I'm not the same, they relate. We do this for the cake.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back. You're tuned into your Feel Good Breakfast Show Express, right here on SABC3. Man, there's a couple of minutes left of your Feel Good Breakfast Show this morning. It's a Friday. We're feeling good. We're feeling the love, clearly.
You can't stop with me.
Pretty much.
Listen, before we wrap up the show, yesterday is a positive message brought to you by Neurobian.
That's right. And our quote for this morning is, willpower, like a muscle, needs to be strengthened. Mm. So take time over the weekend to set realistic goals and challenge yourself during the week to reach them.
Willpower.
Beautiful.
It's all
about the willpower. That's where it starts.
Power.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Are you guys ready for a dance?
Yeah.
We are ready for a Friday dance.
Let's get this Friday on fire.
You said on fire. We're going to blow the roof off this place. Dude, thank you so much, VJ, Jono, in the house this morning.
How you doing?
Dude, in the presence of greatness today, which we absolutely love, and it seems like an awesome time to be in South Africa, to be doing what you do. I've got to ask the VJ title. How does one earn the title of VJ? We've seen you on the decks. We know your prowess, but how did you get into the game from that angle?
Look, I always wanted to be a little bit different in what I do, so I started doing video mixing. So it's basically like DJing, but you play music videos, right? So you can imagine a big stage event with big screens and stuff, and the music videos of the songs would be playing while I'm playing my set. So that's sort of where VJ came from.
Let's talk about what's going down now in your life. How excited are you about this weekend, Vim?
I'm pretty excited about this weekend. I had to hire a film crew just so I can get it. It's going to be crazy.
So what can we expect from the show itself? How do you take what you do to a level, an international level now?
I always tell all of my friends that I dropped the bomb. I'll be bringing you the hits that you know and love in a bit of a different way. You know, I might even be teasing you guys with a little bit of a song of mine that's not quite out yet.
Man, I love it. We love exclusives. We love to see South African artists achieving what you are achieving right now, dude. It is phenomenal. So thank you so much for joining us this morning. Taking our Friday to another level entirely. You're gonna round us off with our Friday dance. I'm gonna get the coloreds in here. Boys, get in here. And we are gonna break it down. This is your opportunity at home to get in on the Friday dance. So whatever you are doing, put it down, loosen up, warm up. Time to take it to another level. It's Friday dance time!
I'm trying to change this present to a pimp. Pop a bottle of the Hollywood dip. She said she was a man of freedom. I'ma get it any type of way. If it's real, then you say it to my face. I'm proud to say my name, I'm not the same, they relate.
Don't let me down. Don't let me down. Don't let me down.
Mix
mixing it up with VJ Chano.
Masterpiece. Hey. 10 bad babs and they after me. Bad. One bad bad look like a masterpiece. Looking for a dunk like an athlete. Big drip, what you call it?
Big drip.
Ice chain, peeled water.
Ice.
You got the cab, but can't afford them.
Cash.
You got the bad, but can't afford them.
Two step.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Two step. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Two step. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Two step. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Two step. Oh, yeah.
She can get a taste. She can get a taste. What did it say? It's all the same like Mary Kate. She can get a taste. Let you get a taste. Do you let it taste? Yeah, that's cool, but he ain't like me.
I love it, man. Skrilla Cruel Summer is going down at the Fires Football Arena, Century City, tomorrow. It kicks off at 2 o'clock. It's going to be an unbelievable party. Tickets priced $120 to the VIP experience at 2,100. It's going to be an unbelievable experience. So proud of you, dude. Well done for getting this off the ground. It's going to be a phenomenal opportunity to see the best of South Africa on offer. So we're going to give the lads a little bit of an opportunity to catch their breath and move into another performance to see us out on this Friday. You got another banger for us? Can you drop it? He's got it. He's got a whole set. You can take it away. We're going to bring the boys back in the colours to see us off in style. It's a Friday dance opportunity. It's an opportunity to let go of the stresses of the week. We have to say thank you so much for joining us. Thank you to Patty Munro and all of the superstars, Muzi, everyone who has joined us for what has been a phenomenal way to round off an incredible week. For one last time, put your hands together for VJ Jono!
Another feel-good production.